My name's Joshua Balderson, and this is the Hockey Nation. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Joshua here alongside Brendan Fleming from Pay It Forward Sports. He's along for the ride today to help us bring you this game, and we'll be able to talk about some of the things you guys are doing this year a little bit on in the intermissions. But today, what we're going to do is we're going to start you off with a recap video of the games that have happened previously, and then we're going to have a little chat about it before these players get on the ice. Check out the first two games. Four again, coming in the zone. Brown gets that puck on a stick. Centering opportunity shot, and we have a goal as Gideon Aquay puts it in. I believe that was off the stick of Ryan Pelikan out of the zone. Here comes Malachowski in, centering over to the far side shot, and we have a goal. Gideon Aquay, but Gideon's able to get out. Now a 3-on-1. Here's an opportunity. Coming in, centering front shot, and we have a goal. Has good point. Looking for a shot into the corner. Some room. Centering opportunity across it. He scores to make it. Still holding that puck. Centering opportunity shot. Over the net. Glenn McCarty rebounds up his rebound. Gets it back. Tries to center. That can't get. Center play. Scramble. He was paid. Tried to get a shot back.
Goals,
yep.
But you guys definitely brought them on at home, got the home crowd going.
Yeah,
what's your take so far on this?
So the series has come down to what's up. Gideon Aquay is very fast. They're a fast-paced team that turnovers. You can't make mistakes. If you make a mistake, it's in the back of your net. And that has happened many, many times in this series. I thought the Friday night game liner last week was a real close game. I know the score was 4-1, but one was an empty net. It was a 3-1 game. It's a very, very close game. But if you make a mistake, they make you pay. We gotta come into this game tonight and make less mistakes so that we can come out here and get this back to tweet on Sunday.
For sure, and I'm sure Gideon Aquay looking to continue their offensive ways, but adding a little bit of physicality in this game, because like I said, they have been a pretty rough series outside of dropping the mitts. They've been very physical with each other. Brendan, what's your take between these two teams? What are you expecting to see here from the warm-ups?
Well, it's always a good battle between these two teams. I think the main difference tonight is going to come down to goal here. So we got Jake Comet going up against Evan Morrison, two of the top goalies in the league. So I think for Tweed to get a back to game four here to get into Oil Country, Morrison's going to have to stay on his head tonight. And he is very capable of that. He's a great goalie. So I think it's going to come down to Morrison versus Comet tonight. We'll see how it plays out, Super.
Yep. I think this game tonight is going to be a very action-packed game, that's for sure. probably going to be a little physical. And if Bo can stand on his head tonight, we can steal a game and get back to Tweeden. Maybe we can get back in this series and give them a run for their money.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much, Stu, for coming on in. He's doing his live stream over on the Tweeden Network. And we're going to get this one going over here. So other than that, I did notice, like you were saying, in the warm-ups, we saw some things, you know, Selick doing a little stare down over into the tweet area, you know, trying to see who he maybe wants to get going here at the start of the game.
Yeah, for sure. So we got Eric Selick back tonight for Dan Hoffman, their captain. So we missed game one and two. He is back for game three. And in warm-up, he was kind of straddling that red line. He was staring down to the tweet zone, looking at guys, seeing who's trying to give a little intimidation factor. So Selick's here. He's ready to play. He's a big driver for Dan Hoffman. And I'm excited to see how this game plays out. It could be a physical one. Tweed needs to do anything they can to get back to game four in Tweed here.
Tweed definitely has to figure out what they need to do to Gananoque to get Gananoque off their game. Because right now, Gananoque is firing on all cylinders. The passes are fast. They're skating fast. They're bumping the bodies, but they are also taking a bunch of hits. There might have been a spear or something similar to one that took place in game two. I know there's a little bit of altercation in the second intermission going off the ice. So we expect it's going to be a rough one here today, and there'll be some answers to be made on both sides. So right now we have some things going on. We're going to get sighted here. We're going to fire you over onto the Gananoque dressing room as Tweed enters the ice with the referees. Brendan, how's the energy here right now?
It's pumping in here tonight. We got the cowbells going. Reminds me of the old Yardman Arena here back in Belleville with the Belleville Bulls. The crowd in Gann, it's a big crowd. I think we got 300-400 people. We got a great crowd, and it's going to be a good game. I know Tweed's coming out hungry. I know a lot of the guys on the team, they're coming out to win. They want to get back to Tweed tomorrow night. And we'll see how Gananoque comes here. Do they come out intense, try to bury them tonight? Or do they come out a little lackadaisical and let Tweed back in? So it's going to be a great game. Curious to see how it plays out here, Josh.
Led by Jake Komet, here come the Gananoque Islanders to start off game three of this best of five series. Gananoque's up 2-0. What's going to happen here tonight? Does Tweed stop Gananoque's winning in this series and try to get back into it? Or does Gananoque finish off Tweed? It's do or die for Tweed tonight. Let's get ready here as they're going to do the starting lineups. I think they...
Start, so I can figure it out.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we hope the audio is good here. This is our first time doing a two-person stream here from two microphones, so we're going to hope for the best of it. Again, my first time, so we'll see what happens. But we're going to get her going here as we get ready for this game here in Gananoque. Refs are getting ready to come to the face-off circle as they get ready to drop the puck here. Jake Komet had an amazing game in Tweed. Morrison had a great game here in Gananoque. Let's see who comes out on top. We have Doherty coming into the faceoff circle here to face off against Higgs. Doherty's going to win that one back. Get a hold of it quickly as they kick it back in. Jones trying to grab it around. Sends it to the far side as he's looking to get the puck up. Puck sent up through center ice all the way down. Is it going to be enough for icing? No. Quick onto it is Gann as it come around. Chipping it up into the neutral zone. But turn right back is the Oil Kings getting in by Nez. Duchesne grabs that one up. Looking to get out. Sends it up through ice. Can't connect with anybody as Tweed spins it right back in the neutral zone. And they're going to chip it into the zone. But offside's the call as Ingram went offside.
Yeah, Tweed came out hard here in the first minute. Lots of dump and chase, getting in the forecheck. Looks like they came to play tonight, trying to push this game four. Here we go. We got line two coming out here. We got Captain Murray Free, Rhino, and X-Squall Storm, later Drew Dowdy, Tyler Melanson there in the middle. So Tweed's pushing here early.
Face off one quickly by Tweed, back to the D, and then sent across the ice as they're going to try to enter into the Gananoque zone. Onto the side of the net, quickly played by Kinnett to Duchesne. Duchesne's going to get it around this far side. Shot coming from the point tip right in front as that one's going to get whistled down on a high stick.
High stick, that came close there. Big shot from BMO, Brody Morris from the point. We got Rhino in front of the net. Tweed still put on the pressure here. We got some talking here going on early. Looks like the intensity's going to ramp up between these two teams in game three.
Based off one of the sideboards, Gananoque Stevens chips it back to D. They go D quick and then send it up the ice to neutral zone, where it's broken up by Tweed. They grab control in their zone as they get back to break out the play in behind the net around this close boards here. They're going to send it up to neutral zone with a good chip there. Made by Free, but then a little bit of a collision. Players down. And a shot coming. Goes off over the corner, grabbed up quick by Stevens. Down behind, centering opportunity. Couldn't get it, but still stuck on the stick. Shot. And that one grabbed up, wrapped around the boards. Is it going to go over into the corner? As it's in the feet. Gananoque still sticking with it. Selleck gets it over to Stevens. Shot on. And a save made by Morris.
Big save by Morris. And we had a turnover down in the Tweed end there. Tweed's got to eliminate the turnovers. We heard from Super before the game. Gananoque's been capitalizing their chances on turnovers. Tweed needs to control the puck down there on their own end and get it out.
Willoughby comes in, face off here against Harris. Puck now out of the zone. Turned over though, right at the line. Smith chips it in, couldn't connect as they'll go in deep. And he chipped around the boards by Harris. A little bit of collision there in front of the officials. Play made, keeping that in at the blue line. As Harris gets back to it, centers it, couldn't get onto the stick, and just out of the reach of Latimer, as here comes Tweed, centering across, couldn't connect as it goes off over into the corner. Quick onto it is Smith, who puts it behind his net, around to the far side. Quick grab by Gananoque as they send it to this close side. Smith couldn't get that cleanly as Tweed turns it back the other way, in behind Gananoque's net, and over to the far side boards. A little bit of a bump as Tweed gets in front. Couldn't get one by Komet, and then picked up quickly and taken out of the zone by Gananoque. Sent down onto the stick of Elson as he's looking to get out of the zone. Chips it up to the blue line. Shot coming. Blocker saved on Crothers. Knocked down by Komet. As it gets out of the zone here for Gananoque. Coming in, Higgs looking. Chopped off his stick in behind the net. Wrapped around the boards to the blue line. Kept in by Duchesne. Chipped in front of the net. Now to play.
Tweed had a great chance there on that 2-1. Josh Komet comes up very big with a save. That's why Gananoque brought him over from the trade deadline. He's been a wall between the pipes, and Tweed's got to figure out a way to get him by him here.
Battled in behind the net. Tweed tries to get up to the sideboards, does get up. Ingram has it, looking, tries to put it forward, but it's broken up by Gananoque and chipped as it was just out of the reach of Domingo, who's been a great addition here for Gananoque. In front, shot chipped, and they couldn't get it into the net. Gananoque player is in underneath Morrison.
Lots of commotion from the Tweed net here. Gananoque still pressing, but Tweed's keeping it out. We're 4 minutes into the first period here, still 0-0. 3-2 shots for Tweed. Face-off coming up in Tweed zone.
Duchesne was the one who crashed into Morrison there. Came from the D on that one as he was rushing in, pinching, which is not where he usually is, but gave a little bit of trouble there. Gananoque keeping that puck in the zone off of the faceoff, moving it around, looking to get that one towards the net, over to the far side. Shot chipped in front of the net, and then they couldn't get the rebound to settle down as they keep that puck moving in behind the net. Tweed will chip it up to the sideboards, misses everybody, gets out, is now Tweed has an opportunity coming in, shot on Komet, just wide the net, and out of the zone as it's chipped in the neutral zone, held up by Tweed. They'll turn back the other way, looking, drop pass. Couldn't get it, tried a second drop pass, couldn't get that one over. Gananoque strips the puck.
And the first call of the game goes against Gananoque. I believe we got an interference call coming up against Doherty. Tweed's going to the power play, looking for one early here. Looks like Alex Reese is going to the box for the interference on Doherty, and Tweed's coming out with the first power play unit here. We got Captain Murray Free, Rhino, and Tyler Melikan, former superstar in the Swiss League as well.
Face off here with 16:20 on the first power play near Dixon. He got it back to the point but couldn't get out as it stays in the zone, sent over to the far side, looking for a drive as Jones couldn't get that one on net. In behind, battle over in the corner. Back to the point. They send it back into the corner, looking, shot wide net, comes over this close side here, kept in at the blue line. Back to the point, send far side, looking, driving across, shot from the side, and we have a goal here.
Number 16, Andrew Reinhold. From number 6, Will Jones, what a pass, and Tweed's on the board early with a power play goal. 1-0 Tweed. What a great pass from Will Jones there playing the point. Good cover by Ellison on the other side. That was a great power play by Tweed. And they're up 1-0 early here on Gananoque.
This is where Tweed wants to be in this game, not trailing. They want to be ahead. And they're going to start off the scoring here early on the power play. 4 minutes, 8 seconds into this period.
Here we go. Selleck's getting into it on the corner. I think it's with Cicoli over there on the wing.
A little bit of a twist on to Selleck, but Selleck rolls it off. Nothing starting yet. We'll keep an eye on that as Tweed looking to pressure. Here comes Verveek. Shot! And Verveek scores to tie the game just like that as Gananoque has no issues with having firepower, and Verveek just showed it there.
Number 61, Ryan Verveek comes out the 2-on-1. He fakes the pass, going over to Selleck on their side, and he goes low blocker on Morrison. Good goal and a very big response to Gananoque. That could have been Tweed's first lead of the series, and it didn't last long, folks. We got a game here at the Lou.
Verbeek and Rhino, both big key players on these teams, and you can see both starting and getting a goal here early in this first period before the first 5 minutes is over.
Yeah, tensions are ramping up here. The refs are over talking to the winners. I think we got Tricoli over there involved with someone. I can't catch the number on Gan, but they are talking on the wing.
That's number 22, I think that's Wyatt Cota. I don't have him on my list, but I believe that is Cota here.
Cota still going to Cole here, Cota with the puck. And he's firing it across far to Smith. We got another 2-on-1, Smith over, blocked by Bemo.
Puck in behind the net, chipped on, and a whistle quick. That puck's going to go to play, and that's going to stay inside the Tweed zone.
Here comes Tweed, we're about 5 minutes in, 1-1 is the score. We have, looks like Dustin Maines coming to take the draw for Tweed here against Brock Higgs, a big goal score for Gananoque.
Faceoff scrambled in the feet, one to the sideboards by Tweed as they chip it on the boards to the point. Brown keeps it in as they drive here. Brock Higgs has it, looking for an outlet pass as he backs up, back to Graham Brown on the point. Centering opportunity tip just wide of the net as it comes over. It'll be picked up quickly by Millington as he gets it out of the zone and all the way down the ice. And it'll be grabbed up by Komet. He's going to play it. Has some trouble as the Tweed Oil Kings player was crashing in on him. And that puck comes over just out of the reach of Brock Higgs. As that'll get turned back. Gananoque has to turn it though as they grab it up quick in the neutral zone. In over the blue line, driving in comes Brown. Chipped off his stick and then sent back where Palakowski was covering up to keep that puck in the zone. High hit there on Duchesne.
2-on-1 for Tweed, here we go. The shot, big save, pad save by Komet there. Maine's coming down on the far side. Oh, we got a penalty here. I think this is going against Tweed here.
High hit there on Duchesne by the Tweed player. We got it just on the camera in time, and it looks like that's gonna cost Tweed.
Millington's going to the box here. We'll see what it is. I think two probably for outgoing. We'll see what the ref calls here.
Holding.
I've never seen an elbow to the head be called a hole before, but hey, something new every night.
Brendan, you're going to learn a lot here with these EOSHL referees. They do things a bit differently. Faceoff coming to the right of Morrison in the Tweed zone. Gianacque back to the power play, looking to get another one in here, as we've only played down 5 minutes and 27 seconds in this first period. That puck won back to the point, crept up over to Duchesne. Duchesne sends it in, gets order to Verbeek. Verbeek back to Duchesne. Duchesne, shot, tip, comes to the side of the net. Can't get that one to go in. It takes as it, sends it back around. He grabbed up quickly by Verbeek. Verbeek looking, sends it to far side, but it's tipped up, stays in the zone. Chipped off, down opportunity.
Here comes Jared Doherty down on the breakaway. Oh! Johnique with a little hook there, goes away with it. Good puck to the stick.
What? Man, that definitely looks like it could have been a misplay.
And we got a water ball flying onto the ice here. I do not know who threw that. That came off Tweed's bench, angry at the ref. Could it be Coach Johnny Desjardins, maybe?
I believe
we'll
that's
going
to be another
here.
Call coming to Tweed here for throwing the water bottle on the ice.
Yeah, Josh, I didn't catch it through that water bottle, but after the trip, the water bottle clearly was chucked across the ice here. I'm not sure who it was. We'll see what those zebras land on, and we'll see what goes on
looking
here.
Looking at me like there's going to be a bench minor call coming, as they probably can't identify who did it. But the door opens up in Tweed's penalty box. So another player coming in to join.
No one's going to the box yet. I don't know if there's a call or not. We'll see what happens.
Well, the player right there did open the door, so you would
think.
They're going now. Yeah, so a player has entered in to the penalty box from Tweed.
To me, that looked like a clean lift of the stick there. It looked like a great play by Danique coming back. So maybe we get a replay on that later in the first intermission, Josh. It looked like a clean stick lift here, and Tweed is frustrated early.
There's no replays on this broadcast, Brendan. No replays.
Not yet, Josh.
We're working. One day we want to get these replays. But Gann's going to a 5-on-3 here early in the first period at 6-minute mark.
This is a huge moment in the series right here. Tweed needs to kill this off and stay 1-1 here. They got a minute 25 left.
This is going to be a long minute 25 as Gann's good at moving the puck around. Duchesne far side, back to Duchesne up high in the slot. Over to Verbeek, Verbeek looking, sends it across the ice, tip that puck.
Good stick by Melton.
And the weird bounce gets off of the stick and all the way down.
We got 1 minute left in the first penalty here. 5-on-3 still for Gananoque. And here comes Duchesne down.
Shane sends it in around. It's back to the point to Domingo. Domingo looking, sends it down to the far corner to Duchesne. Duchesne paddling back to the D, looking, sends it in, gets it onto the stick of Verbeek. Verbeek down and low. Centering out, Verbeek, a good hard shot right in close, and a save made by Morrison.
That's a big save by Morrison there, John. 39 seconds left in the first penalty. Big save. He's got to keep it quiet here for the next 39 seconds. And Tweed's got to kill these penalties here. Big moment in the series. Gananoque stick with the number one unit here, so they're looking to score.
Faceoff one, misses everybody all the way down the ice, rolling towards Komet, who's going to come out and play it. But a little bit of confusion, and Verbeek had to scramble back to get that puck. Now Domingo coming in, looking, shot just over the net as it comes around to the sideboards, kept in at the blue line. Now holding it, sending it across. Domingo looks again, shot, and he scores!
Soft one, I think, Josh, kind of squeaked between the glove and the pad of Morrison there. I bet that's when he wants to have back, as he reviews that later on.
Kevin Domingo doing what he can to get Gann into the position they want to be. And right now, 2-1, Tweed has started to be getting a little scared because Gananoque has not held back on scoring in this series.
No, Gann looks like they could be running away with it here. They still got 54 seconds left in the first penalty. They are on a 5-on-4 here. That throw in the water bottle, losing their composure. Good hurt tweet here. They cannot allow another goal on this penalty kill here.
4-4 of the shots, and it's 2-1. So right now, scoring coming often.
Yeah, we're only 6 minutes in, 3 goals here. And we got a conversation going on the bench here between Johnny Desjardins and the ref. I wonder what says about here, but they're going at it pretty good. They're frustrated about something. Tweed is trying to work any angle they can to get the next call and get back on that dangerous power play.
54 seconds of power play time remaining for Gananoque. And you have to think they're going to look to get another one in here quick and get right back on it as Palakowski scrambled draw, one by Tweed though, but Gananoque grabs it up quickly behind in their zone, moving it out now into the neutral zone, sends it to the far side as Gann Winter into the zone, sends it in deep, bouncing puck, Stevens gets it, chips it, it gets sent back here to Brown on the point, Brown looking, sends it over to Domingo, back to Brown as that bouncing puck gave Brown a little bit of problem, gets it in deep. As they keep it moving to Palakowski, back to Brown. Brown keeps it in the zone. As they get out to Kota, over. Couldn't get that cell down as Stevens chipped it. And now he'll come out of the zone by Nelson, who's gonna send it far side. Here's an opportunity, shorthanded. Shot and save by Komet.
Will he come down there on the off wing there? Takes a shot, come down with a big save. And 11 seconds left in the first penalty here. Tweed looks like they're going to be second one, sorry. Tweed's going to kill it off. And they're going to look to get back on the offense at 5-on-5. The scoreboard has not been updated here yet at the rink, so it is 2-1, folks, for anyone seeing that.
Yeah, they're a little slow sometimes with the scoreboard. 7-7 are the shots. And now that puck moving down, sent up ice. Chip by and out of play. There's going to be a whistle. I believe this is going to be going out in front again. Gananoque's, no, center ice, it looks like the official is showing.
And we're back to even strength here. Tweed coming back out with Murray 3, Rhino, and Malkin.
Face off one to the close boards here, played quickly in, all the way down around Gann's net, high net. Komet plays it, gets it just by the Oil Kings player. Chip grabbed up, stripped here, Tweed comes in looking. Trying to drive in by the net, good body there made. So it comes over into the corner, turn back onto the stick of Latimer. Latimer holding that puck in behind the net, sends it up to the blue line. They try to chip it out. They're able to get out, bouncing puck, causing Cody Smith a little bit of issues. He tries to center it, but stopped up by the D for Tweed. And then they chip it out of the zone. Here they come, driving up through the neutral zone, in and around. As Melikon couldn't get that one in, sent to net. As they keep battling. Centering opportunity, misses everybody, comes out, Smith grabs that one up, he's gonna leave it, and now they're driving into Tweed zone. They can't get that one to settle down. Centering opportunity, just bounced before it gets to the stick of Duchesne, grabbed up by Harris, because he's gonna spin it back the other way. Chipped at the blue line in by Duchesne, but they send it right back. Good play made by Duchesne with the active stick of the blue to chip that one back, and it'll go in deep behind the Tweed net. They backpedal it.
And Allure here with the puck, he's gonna put it down low here. Up to Ingram. And Tweed's gonna regroup here, get a line change.
Tweed.
Full change here as we're 10 minutes in, halfway through the first period.
Tweed definitely needs to find something here to get back into their offense, as they've been struggling a little bit here since Gann was able to get those 2 goals. Puck pinched off along the board, digging hard as it comes out. And Domingo got it, far side, sends it across. They're gonna bust in, centering in front, Domingo diving across! And that one was saved by Morrison. Puck goes off this side, and we have a penalty. What? As you can see right now, it looks like Darren Doherty arguing with the referee that that shouldn't be a call, but they took down Domingo on the way to the net.
Huge save by Morrison there, Josh. He sprawled across, get that pad save. And yeah, it looks like Doherty's going to the box. 2 minutes for hooking, it looks like. And Gananoque is gonna go back to that dangerous power play, and the number one unit comes over the boards.
Verbeek wins that draw over to the winger, back to the point. Brown sends it over back into the slot. Verbeek had a hard time handling that, puts it back to the slot, shot, and we have a goal. I'm not sure if that was tipped in front of the net or not by Selick. They're celebrating with him. And I think Selick, in his return, gets himself a goal.
And that's what the captain does. Former NHLer Eric Selick, former fourth Panther, Arizona Coyote. He's all in front of the net there. Big tip. makes it 3-1 Gananoque with 10 minutes left in the first period here. And Tweed needs to do something to change the tone here. They might need a scrap or a big hit here to get back and go and play their game.
Gananoque definitely gaining the control of this game where they want to be right now. But an opportunity here as Funk comes in, shot on to Komet, save made. As that one goes off to the corner, as they're going to chip it to the blue line.
Dominique goes wide on Jones, cuts the net, big save Morrison there. He's got lots of speed, 17 there. He's a big trade deadline acquisition from the center racing ice line. Here we go, we got a break. Scores! Ian Cipolli with a breakaway goal, a hustle play, and he makes it 3-2. A huge goal for the Tweed Oil Kings there. That's just purely a hustle play there. Tricoli sees the puck open. He goes for a skate. He drives past the Gananoque defender and goes in and puts it past Komet. Huge goal, 3-2.
It's not 12-3. It's 2-3, ladies and gentlemen. That's fixed up now. And that puck onto to Dixon's stick sends it over to the far side. They chip it up to the neutral zone. Gananoque has been putting on hard pressure after they score. And here they go again as Verbeek tried to drive it into the net. Got tied up with a couple players. But Gananoque very fast back on it, not letting those goals slow them down at all. As they turn it back here for another opportunity, stopped up in front of the net as they'll get grabbed up here. Selick is on the ice, maybe out there looking to start something as we come into the 11 minutes into the first period here.
Ellison regroups here, fires it down to Ingram, Ingram with a turnover. Jones fires it back, goes back to Morrison here, and Tweed's going to regroup. Long pass here by Morrison, good look actually. And we got Doherty coming back just out of the penalty box. He's looking to score, he's got Doherty and Ingram. Big save by Komet there. That was a tricky little stop there, going low on the ice to the net.
Another good save by Komet there. See, he was able to kick that one right to the blue line. And now an opportunity for Gann, but a little bit of a stumble by Maimon as he was trying to work that blue line. Puck keeps in, looking, bouncing by the net. That's going to go over into the corner. Quick Gann onto it, back to the point. Shot coming into the slot. Puck bouncing. Tweed getting onto it, but chipped into the close boards here. Tweed's got to curl back as Higgs is trying to get onto it. Far side now up to the blue line, chipped in and just offside. The official calls it on the line.
Boy, Josh, I'm telling you, if you're a better, if you took the over tonight, you're really happy right now. We got 5 goals, 12 minutes in. We're looking like we're heading to an 8-7, 9-8 type of game. I can't wait to see how this plays out. Both teams are just motoring tonight. Lots of determination. Johnny Desjardins is still on the refs here. I do not know what's going on that Tweed bench. They are not happy with the officiating right now. This is the third or fourth talk the coach has had to the ref. We'll see what's going on. Maybe we'll go down and try to talk to Johnny on the intermission here, because Tweed is not happy with the officiating, point blank.
Well, you definitely can see a lot coming from that Tweed bench. And right away, so they're in a do or die game, so they need to be coming out with anything. They got to fight for it all, right?
Oh, they're using every trick in the book tonight. I'm sure Coach, their GM John's there working the ref, just trying to get the next call and get back on that power play. Got Ellison behind the net here. Over to McCann. McCann, one of the most underrated defensemen in the league here, plays every game for Tweed on that right side with Brody Morris, and one of the top pairings in the league. And Smith coming down, breaking into the zone, shot on net, saved by Morrison. And Tweed looks to turn it around here. We got Mains, goes over to Crothers. Crothers gets in deep, and Tweed's gonna get on the forecheck here, looking, they got some big bodies out on the ice. And there's a turnover, Tweed needs to get back. Smith coming down the far side again. Back to Brown, Brown shot blocked. Big block there. And if Tweed moves here, they can have a 2-on-1. They go for line change, turns to 1-on-1 here. Looks like Mains coming down. Just trying to buy some time.
Takes a double hit there by the Gann players.
And Melanson in the corner, Mames up. Oh, and we got a turnover here. Coming through the middle is Wiley. Wiley coming down 1-on-4 here. He's looking to buy some time. Jones pursues, Rhino pursues as well. Gananoque still has that puck in his own. That was a good play there by number 5. In front, scores! Number 92, Brock Higgs, I believe a former Kings in front, that makes it 4-2 for Gananoque, and the over we're still trending, ladies and gentlemen. 4-2 with 7 minutes left in the first period. And this line in Arkansas, Josh, has been Hicks and Dominique all night. And Verbeek have been the big players for Gananoque so far.
Definitely. Hicks seems to definitely turn it up even a little bit more in these high stress games, you know, the playoff games, the ones that matter. He's there to put on some big points.
Those are the type of players you're looking for. Maybe we'll get him on the Toronto Maple Leafs. We're looking for some playoff performers. The deadline comes up here, too. 1 week later, the NHL trade deadline. And all of Gananoque's deadline acquisitions are paying dividends, too. And Komet and Dimon Dominique.
Puck in the corner gets scooped out. And now Gananoque still controlling it, though, in this Tweed zone. Not giving Tweed much time to work with anything with the pressure. As we said, they got this two-goal lead back here, and they're looking to make it three as they want to have those insurance markers here. Puck kept in, just chipped up into the slot. Gananoque still holding possession. Big shot from the point. And we have a goal!
Number 10, Chris Latimer, fires a shot from the point, and it goes in off the Tweed defender. I believe that was Braden Allure in front of the net. And you gotta be good to be lucky, and that was a lucky one for Gann, as it was just a nonchalant dunk into the corner, a shot on net. And we got a goalie change here, Josh. It looks like that's the end of the night for Morrison. In comes Troy Webster. Tweed's looking to do anything they can to shake it up here.
Well, Chris Latimer, hometown, homegrown Gananoque boy, gets it 5-2. And with the goalie change, they're going to let him get a little stretch here. 6-0-2. We haven't even made it through one period yet here, Brendan.
I told you, Josh, bet the over, and we got some more words coming from Tweed's bench here. That was a tough one for Morrison to get pulled on. I mean, it was nothing he could do, just tipped in front of the net by his own player, nothing he could do there. But Tweed has dug themselves a hole, and they are going to have to mount a comeback here, down 5-2. 5 minutes on the first.
I don't want to say the celebration had anything to do it, but when you have a D celebrating at center ice after he scored on you, the ref or the coach sometimes might get a little ticked at that one.
Yeah, for sure. Wayne might be on the faceoff. Big stop by Komet there. He is just a wall back there. He looks very composed. Looks like a Justin Wall back there in net.
Faceoff kept in the zone by Brown. Chip back in deep. Good move there. Salah keeping that puck active and low. And that puck's going to come all the way out.
Coming high stick. Coming in on 13, Justin Stevens from Gananoque. Tweed's going to go back to the power play here, guys, and they're going to look to make it 5-3. Could we have an 8-goal period? Let's see how this plays out on the power play for Tweed. It looks like the first unit's coming back out.
Stevens having some words here with the officials. Not that it's going to do him any good, especially not a linesman. They're not the ones you're going to want to make that with.
It was an incidental contact. He was firing. He was taking us. Taking a swing in the pocket, the stick kind of came up. But they've got Doherty in the face.
Faceoff in deep in the Gananoque zone, down for 2 minutes as it gets cleared all the way out down the ice. Tweed will chase it down by Will Jones, who's going to grab that up behind the net. Cycles back, he has Selick looking, but they're going to get it by, bringing it in. Chip pass, cross this ice, couldn't get in, and sent in all the way down the ice. As that will stay in at the blue line, keeping it down deep is Tweed back to the blue. As they keep that move around, Jones has it, sends it towards the net, but it gets broke up. They got a shot and a save, and now they're looking to keep that moving. But as we said, Komet, big as well, big and big games, is showing it right here as he's keeping Gananoque with it. Tweed still pressuring, puck cleared out of the zone, all the way down, be met up by Webster. And it'll be turned back now as Tweed's looking to get it down. Stopped up was Purdy. He took a little bit of a bump there. Gets him behind the net. As Duchesne tugged down. Tweed has it. As it comes back to the point, looking. Good move there made as they're trying to get in. Back pass here. Purdy with it. Chips it over to the far side. Looking to get a shot at the net. And a good save made by Komet. Comes over to this close side. On to Nelson. Back to Purdy. Over to the far side. Shot coming. And Jones, that hit the leg of a Tweed player on the way through, and Gananoque picks it up and clears it up. Here's a chance for Gann. Brockhead shot, and a good save made by Webster.
Tweed in transition here. Here comes Ellison, taking it in, dumped in deep. Now Rhino's going to chase it. Tweed's got 30 seconds off the power play, very free. Down low to Rhino. Little stick check there, no call by the ref. And Gananoque clears it, and that could end this power play here for the Tweed Oil Kings. One last rush here, 13 seconds left on the power play. Fired in by Murdoch.
Good save made there by Komet. Again, slowing things down. He is showing right now. He's up to the task.
Yeah, Tweed's doing a lot of these soft little tip plays from the point. Looks like they're trying to bring guys out from the corner in front of the net and for these little tip plays. And it did work on the first goal a little harder, but they might need to fire on Komet here.
So the faceoff is going to have Mainz come in here across from Selick. As we're going to get a Selick center faceoff. That doesn't happen too often. We'll see it here, but he wins it back.
Win by the NHLer too.
And he's going to keep on it. Body is bouncing over there, as you can see. Good save made by Kent, but the physicality turning up here now.
We're all even. Penalty's over in front of Mainz. Oh! Tweed still digging here. Getting off, they turn it around.
Kyle Cassie comes in, stops at the blue, sends it across to Smith. Backhand shot, good save made by Webster. As Tweed's going to get that puck in possession, get out of their zone, but only to the neutral zone where they turn it over. Gananoque grabs it up, but having a little bit of issues with Millington, sends over to the far side. Gan needs some space, and they're able to get it up. Chip here, now Wayman coming, only has one to beat. Shot, and that one hit the body of the D and then trickled to the net.
Yep, 3 minutes left here in the first period. We got 16 to 10 on the shot for Tweed, so they are on them here, looking to mount a comeback. We got a face-off in Tweed zone. Who's coming out? We got Selick coming back out, playing the wing with Verbeek and Stevens. Stevens line up high, waiting for that shot. We'll see if Tweed can get to that. Big win here, straight to Tweed. We got Tricoli going to the same place where it's going. A little flip, skate on it, couldn't make it that time. Verbeek coming back though. Verbeek comes in on Jones, fake shot, saved by Webby.
Puck gets to the point. Pitch. Good pinch there by Duchesne, but that one goes up and out of play as Duchesne got onto that stick. He was coming in with some speed.
Yeah, Duchesne was coming in with some damage. Tricoli with another play where he just kind of flips in the neutral zone and tries to use his speed to get by the defense when all he's looking. Couldn't quite do it that time. We'll see that something we see more from Tricoli as Tweed looks to mount their comeback here in game three of round one of the USHL playoffs.
Selick. They dropped the puck with Selick still setting up. I haven't seen that too often other than in minor hockey, but it happened here. Now Tweed gets that puck, gets it out of the zone as they're trying to get it in. Chipped on, good play there made by Selick to bump the body, and the puck gets grabbed by the D for Gann as they do a little D to D and then send it up to the neutral zone, stopped by Ingram. But Verbeek and Selick there, and Selick gets that puck, chips it in, kept in by Stevens, shot just wide, comes to the side of the net. As Selick sticks with it, chips it back to D. Duchesne chips it right back to where it came from. But then it gets sent out. Brown will chase it down. As they'll go down for icing in behind Komet's net.
Yeah, we got an icing here. Pluck coming back into the Tweed zone here. And Selick was big on that forecheck there. It looks like some of the defensemen don't want to handle Selick down low. And who can blame him? He looks like a man on his point over there sometimes, big. 6'3", 220-pound, former NHLer. I wouldn't go in the corner with him too much either.
Definitely some guys that wouldn't mind going against them, but he does have quite a stature out there on the ice. Face up one here.
Scores! Gananoque right off the draw.
I can't be there. I need that move.
And we got a goal here by Gann. Off the tip in front, came out. And by Webster, with 6-2 here, 2 minutes left in the first period. 8 goals this first period. Couldn't see this coming, if you predicted it, Josh.
Base off one, grabbed up by Dixon as we have 2 minutes remaining. And that will we get sent out to the neutral zone. Sent in. Over to the far side. Dixon chases it down, can't get to it. His tweet gets to it first, but he still has some time space. We have Latimer trying to get that out, gets up to the side. Boards are still trying to get up, but Tweed battling hard here. Shot in on Komet, stops up that play.
Captain Murray Free trying to lead him back here. Some hard work in the corner, shot in the net. Tweed needs their leaders here. Looks like this first line of Murray, Melanson, and Ryan would be difference makers here. So they're staying out, minute and a half left. And we'll see if the big dogs for Tweed can get one here for the period because it's 6-3.
Face off one. By Gananoque sent up to the neutral zone. trying to spring, couldn't, but the trailing player gets the puck forward to the net. Couldn't settle that one down as Gann still trying to get that puck pinched off in behind the net by Elson. As Gann keeping that puck moving around, sends it in deep. Far across into the slot, Latimer has it, shot, hit the feet. Grabbed up quickly by Tweed as they're gonna get it out of the zone, far side, drive here for Tweed, but chipped off the stick by the D of Latimer, trying to break that puck up. Grabbed up in the neutral zone, turn here now by Gann Aquay.
Get a change here. Give him one of those pop movers near 8 or 4 in the back end, but up here.
His final 45
minute, seconds left in the first. Will Jones circles back. Tweed's going to look to make one last push here. Off to Crothers. Crothers going to come in, dump it in. Tweed's going to be on the fourth to Mazey. Tweed has it down low. We got the big guys out here. We got Dustin Maines and Pat Millington. Two of the bigger bodies on Tweed. Let him do some damage down low as the puck comes out. Another hit here by Maines. 20 seconds left. Tweed with one last rush here coming up. Shot on net, kicked away by Kement. Millington in the corner. Millington and Maines going to work down low. By Crothers. Just missed. That is the end of the first period. Gann Aquay, ladies and gentlemen. It is 6-2 for the Islanders, and Tweed's going to look to make some adjustments here as they come into the first period and come into the second.
So what a first period this has turned out to be here so far between these two teams. So basically, the physicality has been picking up, but the scoring hasn't stopped. 8 goals in one period. Looks like the shots up on the scoreboard right now, 13 Gann Aquay, 18 for Tweed. So about... 31 shots so far in this game, 8 goals. And some physical play that's been coming here, and some yelling here is coming off.
But Josh, both physical and offensive. Like I said, 8 goals in one period, don't see that too much. A goalie pull. I thought Morrison got the raw end of the stick there on that 5th goal. I know one of them was weak, I think the second one on Dominique, but he's looking to come back here, and we'll see Webby come out for the second, and Tweed's going to look to mount their comeback here.
I definitely expect we might see some... I don't want to say we're going to have fights, but
we're gonna have fights, people.
It is getting towards, you know, without the right players on the ice. I can't see Tweed going through this whole series without dropping the mitts once against Gann Aquay.
Well, Tweed is a team that will do anything to win. They got some old school guys, including their trainer, Chris Rutledge, over on the bench there, filling up the water. So Tweed's going to pull any trick in the book they can to get back, guys. I'm telling you, Tweed's going to come hard. If the dump and chase game isn't working, they're going to switch to plan B. Coming out for the second period, they're going to come hard, I guarantee that.
Well, I expect, yeah, you're going to see them come out. First thing you're going to see is just bodies flying into bodies, trying to get Gann off their game and see what they can do. So now we're going to do something real quick here. We're going to run to a real quick commercial ad. It's for Pay It Forward Sports. Then we're going to come back. You're going to give a little bit more information before we kick into this intermission. So check out Pay It Forward Sports.
Somebody that knows somebody that knows something about it. And I won't answer now. Who, what, where, why? See, a lot of dudes like to act the fool. Now I'm getting on live, but that ain't my style. Now who he gon' get and what he gon' do? Run up on me if you want to. Hot damn pressing his homies. He's done up in front of his mama. I'm up the floor with him. And I kick in the door and let the fofo hit him. I got fools that'll go get him. This for him, the fool, and the dudes that crack money.
So that was the Pay It Forward Sports. They have a hockey tournament coming up. Brendan, tell us a little bit about it. When is it? What is the prizes, and who can get into it?
Yeah, Josh, so every year at Pay It Forward Sports, we run multiple hockey tournaments, but our biggest one every year is, hands down, the King of Vegas. It's April 5th to 7th in Trenton, Ontario. 4 different divisions, but the main division is the Elite Division. We get teams from all over. We got teams from Montreal, Ottawa, Toronto. So we get all the best beer league teams, not senior A teams. We get beer league teams coming down from all over Ontario and Quebec, and they are competing. looking for a team trip to Las Vegas. You win the tournament, you and the boys, you're flying out to Vegas, you're going to Caesar's Palace, and it's a trip of a lifetime. It's something you never get to do with your buddies. All you have to do is come up, win a hockey tournament to get it. So we do have one spot left for that tournament right now. Like I said, right now we have nine of the best beer league team from around Quebec and Ontario coming. But along with that, we have some other divisions too, Josh. We have the intermediate division. If you're just little down from the elite division, maybe Vegas, if you're thinking, come there. We have a recreational division for guys more like yourself, John. And then we have a women's division. For the first time ever, we're going to have a women's event. And for the other three divisions, the winners win a team round of golf for a Pay It Forward sports partner, Rondell Glen Golf Course. So again, either a trip to Vegas or a team routing out on the golf course. You can't beat that. Come on out April 5th and 7th, Trenton, Ontario. Check it out, payitforwardsports.ca.
For sure, make sure you're checking that out. And they're going to have other great events. We'll talk about those in the second intermission. We're taking a little bit of a break for a couple minutes so we can get all prepared back up for the second period. We'll be right back after this intermission. Hi, everybody. We are back here in Gananoque as we're just about getting ready to go here. I set my camera for the second period of play. So I got a little fancy score sheet here for us. We can talk about some stuff. Let me pull it up here.
Josh getting off Grinder account here.
Hey now. So first period, 16-19 were the shots. Anything sticks out here on these goals? Gananoque got scored on, then responds with three each time.
Well, what I can see from the score sheet is it's the big dog for Gananoque to come to play tonight, Jock. We got Verbeek, Dominique, Selick, Hayes, and Paul Twesky.
Palakowski.
Five or six goals, so that's five of their six top players right there. So the Gananoque big dogs came to play, and they have put the puck in the net. Tweed's going to need something similar from their guys. They're going to need Rhino, Murray Green, Doherty to step up here and put some behind him in. It's going to be a challenge here for Tweed. Down 4-1 in the second against one of the best goalies in the league. Tweed's got to come out hungry and maybe a change in game plan here. Maybe not so much dump and chase, but maybe they got to get in, get a bang in the bodies against Gananoque and get them frustrated. That seems to be the way that you can get to them. Get them taking a penalty. So I was Coach Johnny there in the intermission. That's the advice I'd be giving the boys coming out
of
the second period.
For sure. Definitely, they do need to change it up. They need to come out. They have to have a lot more physicality, and they have to have a lot more bite in them right now because they are playing physical, and they are playing, but right now they're not getting anything that's going to throw Gananoque off their game.
That's right. It seems like a pretty low game right now between a lot of dump and chase, a lot of soft shots looking for tips, and they got to do something different. Now they're working the game. The first 7 periods of this series, they got to find a way to get Gananoque frustrated, get them off their game, so we see they're going to step up between here.
For sure, and that's what I think is the only way that right now Gananoque is going to be able to lose this game is if Tweed can get in their head and start causing some issues for them.
Absolutely. Tweed's got to do something different here. They got to start drawing some penalties, making this a dirty game. I know Gananoque likes a dirty game, but sometimes Tweed's got to, they got to switch it up, do something different to get to the front of the net here and get some goals.
For sure. You definitely, Gananoque does thrive when they're physical, but when they're getting it back from another team is when sometimes it can get under their skin.
That's right, you got some hot ends, sometimes you gotta, you know, even if it's not gonna be fun for you and you think you're a match, you gotta go for it. Tweed's gotta go for broke right now, guys. They are down 4 goals, down 2-0 in the series. They gotta throw the kitchen sink at Gananoque here and try to get back in the series and this game.
And that is a hit into the rafters, which you don't see often in Gananoque, but the puck goes up, hits, and stops dead. And that will stop the play here, bringing that puck outside. Actually, might have even been the light, not the rafter, as it was a weird thump. That puck's going to come all the way back out here to center ice. Faceoff one into Gann's zone as Gann's going to start to move that puck around, looking to get it down and start quick. As again, we haven't seen much physicalness yet here in the game as we are only 20 seconds in. I'm expecting to see it start soon. As they go, good shot in on Komet, though. Directed off over to the corner, picked up quickly by Tweed. As they send it back towards the net, can't get it. As it comes around to the point, kept in. Drive towards the slot, sent over to the far boards. Kept in Gananoque zone as Gananoque trying to get it out. But it's kept in at line. Shot coming, bouncing puck up and over the net as Komet got a piece of it.
That just popped right in front. Jones with a shot. In front, Purdy scores! Number 9, Mitch Purdy. 49 seconds into the second period. Cut the lead now, it's 6-3. Big opening shift by the Tweed Oil Kings. Looking to get back in the game here.
So 6-3. Tweed definitely showing that they are willing to battle Gann.
A little bit of lackadaisical start there for Gann. They come out, both the wingers flew the zone early, looking for their cookies. Didn't come, Tweed turns it over, and Purdy puts by the net to make it 6-3.
We definitely have to think the Gann-Tweed into a shoot-off would be more beneficial to Gananoque, but Tweed looks like they have to get into one now at this point.
Everything's on the table right now. We got BMO, former Babel Bowl, pinching from the point here. We got a defensive leading the rush for Tweed. Tweed's coming out looking to throw everything they got at Gann here. Here we go. Melanson in the corner in front. That's a little wide. Selick, Ballon, Rhino. Selick collects the puck here. The big captain, Verbeek, looks to get it up. Good play by McCann on the left side there. This is a great pairing for Tweed. McCann and BMO, one of the best in the league here. So here we go. We got Melanson down. Up to BMO, shot on net just wide. McCann's going to look to keep it in here. Selick's going. We got it kept in. Down low here. Rhino on the forecheck. Out by Stevens. Turnover down low. And Gannon is looking to break out. We got Selick up to Verbeek. Verbeek coming down here again. Nice save by Webby there. And here we go back the other way. Murray. Murray frees the end of a long shift. Not looking to chase that one down. Can we have Chase on ice here? I believe so. Tweed is tired. I'm going to tell you that right now, Josh. This lineup was a hard shift in the offensive zone. Bimo is the first man in. We got a tired offense and defense in between. We'll see if Gannon can capitalize.
Gannon coming out. Harris going to come to the faceoff, looking to win this one, trying to keep them hemmed in their zone. It gets chipped to the blue line. Quick play there by Duchesne, but couldn't get to it as it gets chipped out. And now Tweed's going to be able to get a couple fresh legs on as Gann turns it back the other way, sends it into the far side as that one grabbed up by the glove.
Smart play by Webby there to hold it. You thought BMO told him to keep it in your glove. Could easily play that, but Tweed needed to change. So they're going to get some fresh defenders on the ice. And good thing here, because it looks like McCann and BMO were gassed there. So good play by Webby, good communication by BMO. And we got a faceoff in the Tweed Hall game zone.
Higgs is going to come in, set off on the faceoff here, try to give these guys some trouble, win that faceoff back to the point, shot coming, and that one comes over this far side where Duchesne gets on it, sends it back to the net, bouncing puck grabbed up by Webster, and stopped.
Another save by Webster, we need to start winning the faceoff. Dominique's been unreal on these faceoffs here. We got Dominique and Verbeek, they've been a big presence here for Gannon Ockway. That Higgs coming to take the draw here, I believe that is Higgs, former Kings of Frontenac down the middle anyway. Pinch down here by Brown. And Tweed's got it in there, looks like a lure. Down low here to Murdoch. And Tweed's bringing it. We got Tricoli coming down here with Wilby.
Good play there by Domingo, though, was able to break that one up and get a good stretch up for Gannon-Ockway as they're going to spin back around. Higgs centers it, turned over here to Tweed with an opportunity, but in the way was Graham Brown breaking that one up. He'll get sent back into the Tweed zone. Tweed trying to move this one up and out of the zone. Chips up the neutral zone, stopped up by Gann. Turn back, here comes Higgs. He's not alone, gets it over, coming in. Opportunity, but a spry across. Tweed player broke up the option. Now a shot from the point by Reese. Save. Rebound shot, chipped up and over the net. As Tweed quickly grabs it up, taking it through the neutral zone.
What a bad play by Wilby there down low. With a huge turnover, just missed the net there. Tweed can't have those mistakes to drop in the zone, Josh. That's the second or third one, or the defense zone, sorry. So Tweed needs to take care of the puck when they get in their zone. They got to get it out, get back on the forecheck, get back on the attack.
Definitely can't be doing turnovers here against Gannon-Ockway, down by three in an elimination game.
No, can't happen. Oh, and here we go. Coda coming down on Webby. Shot, big save by Webby. Hits in the mask, play, get blown dead. Good call by the ref there. Safety first.
He's going to check his helmet, make sure there isn't any cracks in it or dents in the cage. Take a couple seconds to get a little bit of a breather before they get that puck drop back here in the zone.
Puck in the neutral zone here. We got a battle between Jones and Murray. Here we go, Ellison here gets the puck up to Crothers. Crothers, big play to get it out. Big hit by Jack Wiley there. Number five, in on the body. Now here comes Tweed. We got Millington and Mames, the two big guys. They look like about 6'3" each out here for Tweed. Looking to go down, Mames with a shot. Turned over, Millington down low battling.
There could be some issues here with Wiley as that hit was high. He got his arms up in the head. And I'm sure Tweed might want an answer for that one.
Nice stop there by Webby with a blocker. Coming on the net. Ellison, been a big force back there. Long lead pass up to Ingram. Ingram coming in, fired on net. Saved by Komet. Gets the face off. 6-3, ladies and gentlemen, for the Gannon-Ockway Islanders. We're 4-5 minutes into the second period here, and we've got a shootout, 23-22 the shots. We got an even game. A couple soft or lucky goals here by Gannon-Ockway are the difference so far. Tweed looking around the comeback. BMO, shot on the point, just wide, in front of Doherty. Oh, Doherty just missed a great chance there. Doherty and Purdy working down low. Also Ingram here on the battle. We got a battle on the half wall. Turned over. Get it off with the break. We got Celik and Verbeek coming down. Verbeek's in. No penalty call. Elementary play a little call.
Good try for Celik there in front of the net. Kick save by Webster.
Ingram coming down. Ingram shot. Bimo! Just missed. Brody Moore's coming down low. Tweedy needs to get back. Their defenseman's in deep. Doherty, good back check. Schoenweiser leader there. Doherty up to Ingram. Ingram, Purdy, and Bimo, and Doherty. Here we go. 4-on-3. Tweedy coming down with a chance. And we got a penalty on Celik. 2 minutes for tripping. Here we come, and Tweed's going back to the power play. Looking to make it 6-4 here. Celik protesting that call here. He's not happy with it. He's going at it, looking for the dive. Still a push. Doherty and Celik, two of the better guys. And we got some chirp. Johnny Desjardins firing at Celik on the bench. I love it here. We got some action here. Gannon Ackway, ladies and gentlemen.
It looks like it could be starting up here. Celik not happy with Doherty, also not happy with the officials. He's got to be careful he doesn't take an extra penalty, but they could be starting up the physical side of this game.
Kepin, oh no, Jones didn't get it. Paul Wesky coming down on the break. Big save by Webby. Keeping it 6-3 here, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a great group. We got Jones, Murray, the first lines out here, with Rhino and Melanson. Down low, former Guelph Storm, Tyler Melanson in the corner. He's looking for Murray. Pops his weak out. Allison's going to retreat. Tweed's going to regroup here. Gannon-Ockley clogging up that middle. Good here. Tweed looking back in the offensive zone. Paul Zwelski and Melanson. Turnover. Here we go. We got Brock Higgs coming in on breakaway. Oh, what a save by Remy. Higgs looks like he tries to let it slide, kind of the old Kucherov all-star play. Good try there, but Webby's up the task. Tweed coming down. Melton, saved by Komet. What action here to get an off-way, guys. 6-3, 13:52 remaining here. We got a minute left in the Oil King power play, and they are going to look to score. Big Brody Morris looking to get that clapper on the point and put one past Komet here.
Definitely the fans are getting their price for admission here tonight between these two teams.
Great game so far. Shot in by Doherty. Saved by Komet. We just fired all sorts of shots on the net here. They are up 26-24 in shots. And they are looking to make it 6-4 and make it a game. 6-4, anything can happen, Josh. Tweed needs the next one.
Jousting going on there along the boards. Looks like they could be heating up some rivalries here between these players.
Can't see the Gannon-Ockley play. Looks like
Domingo.
I don't like you call him Dominique. That's what it looks like. But Domingo, you say, eh?
I don't know. I'm winging it, too.
Oh, I think it's Dominique. Oh, you got me all fooled. Dominique, I'm going to call him that now. Kevin Dominique. Scores! And Brent Relievers Ingram tipped it in at one time. The ref said it's a good ball. And it's 6-4 for the Oil Kings on Celik penalty. Let's see if they scratch it up here. Anything can happen in a 6-4 game. Gannon-Ockley wants to take a look at that. They want the refs to talk about it. The stick was a little high. I think it was under the crossbar. We'll see what the refs decide here.
Definitely is the discussion going on from Celik right now with the official about it being a potential high stick.
And Tweed is fired up now, Josh. Look at the bench. Everyone's standing. Everyone's engaged. The start of the period, it wasn't this way. 2 goals is going to get them back in this game. And Tweed looks to be reinvigorated. I'd love to have the microphone down there, Josh. See what they're talking about between Verbeek and Celik. Gannon-Ockley's all over the refs here. They're looking for an explanation. The refs saying it was under the bar. We got a good goal. And here we go. We look like we got a goal. 6-4 for the Oil Kings. And we've got a game here, ladies and gentlemen. And game 3 of this series.
Face off one here by Tweed into their zone, back D to D as they try to flip it up forward and a stretch pass, center across and the bobbling puck couldn't get centered over into the slot. Shot chipped in the net, couldn't get in as it's grabbed up by Gannon-Ockley behind their net and they'll come down the ice, sending it down to neutral zone. Verbeek has it coming in, has Celik with him. centers to Celek. Celek has it. Tries to spin it around in front of the net. Can't get it. Sends it back to D. On to Latimer's stick. Latimer chips it in. Goes in. Pinches along the deep boards. The guy center it there from Verbeek. Couldn't get it. Back to the point. Shot. And that one comes off over into the corner as Tweed will be able to send it out down the ice. Diving play. Couldn't connect with that one as Gann grabs it up. And they'll chip it here. But that one's going to go up and hit the netting and cause a whistle.
Another big save by Webster. I'm telling you, Josh, he's been a difference maker since he came in. It seems to have given Tweed a little boost. He's made some key saves here in the second period to keep it close.
We actually talked earlier this week, today or yesterday, about how starting goaltenders, I said Webster was on fire, and I thought he definitely deserved a top spot here for the Oil Kings.
Yeah, I know Tweed has always been really high on Morrison. He's a good goalie. Plays in a lot of pay-forward sports tournament as well, so just an off night. But Webby's always been solid for him. I think it's his third year at the club here. He's a big contributor to the team. He's showing why today. He's keeping it in the game.
Yeah. Definitely been doing good in this series when he's been playing, keeping the game close.
And Tweed's fourth line in the forecheck here. We got the big boys. We got Millington, Mames, and Crothers there doing some grinding down low. Gannockley breaks out. Harris coming down low, taking it up. In front of that, big save by Webby! He's on fire there for Tweed. That pops out.
What comes in the zone, offside there. And they try to give him, what a save by Webster.
Webby is on fire here, ladies and gentlemen. That's four or five big saves this period. It could be a 10-4 game right now, but he is keeping him in the second period. And Tweed's looking to get the next one. Megan 6-5, first line for Tweed coming out. And we got number four, Bobby Orr over there, Brody Morris. I can already tell by the look in his face, he's looking to make an offensive contribution from a defensive defenseman. He's pinching here. And all Dominique coming in. Dangerous guy. What a move. Goal! Number 17, Kevin Dominique with his second of the game. An unreal move there. I was now close across the line, but the ref called it in.
And Gann Aukwe responds again to increase a three-goal lead.
Back to 3-7-4 here. It's a rough turnover there for Tweed here. I think they had the fourth line out. And that's a big one for Gann Aukwe here. Make the three-goal lead. Two-goal lead, multi-lead in hockey. So I'm sure they're probably back to three. Tweed's looking to come back again here.
I think he got the first one. I think the secondary, I think, Kevin Domingo stuck with it and was able to slide it in behind.
And last goal score between Ingram Purdy coming down again. Domingue, there, I got you right. And Domingue coming in again. Paul Zemski. Domingue driving that shot, saved by the way. Domingue again, that's a big save by the wrestler there. Will Jones breaking the rush here. Dumping it on Komet. Getting the boys in on the forecheck.
Big drive for a hit from Tweed there. Just missed. Laying out the Gannockwe Wiley.
Big chance there for Tweed. Looks like Tricoli going for number two. Just looks like it tipped off the defender. Wiley went up high. We are 9 minutes into the second period.
Wiley landed a high hit earlier in the game. And he just had one go after him in the far corner by Tweed, another high hit. I think that was retribution from the Tweed player for the earlier hit in this game.
It could be very well, Josh.
Tweed gets the puck, moving it up out of their zones. They're going to look to try to keep this pressure here. But Gann Aukwe doing a great job breaking that up in the neutral zone as they'll get that puck moving down now towards the Tweed zone. Not too much pressure coming out again right now as they're looking to see if they can get Tweed to make a mistake and continue to capitalize on. Good shot here, battle at the side of the net. They're trying to send that front in the slot, bouncing puck, couldn't connect with anybody. Tweed gets there and their stick is here they come. Four on top of Wilby, bounces off his stick, goes over into the corner.
Stellick down low, that guy's everywhere tonight. And he's back, Gann Aukwe's gonna set up and take it by the net and look to mount some offense here. And up through the middle, We got a 3-on-2, 3-on-3 involvement. Stelic to Verbeek. Verbeek shot over the net. That's still in play. Stelic's got it. Nearly the corner. And covered up.
Stelic gave Murdoff a little shove there, but Murdoff didn't seem to engage him too much.
I don't think Murdoff wants any part of Stelic, Josh. That big monster over there, Stelic and Green. I don't think anyone's going to mess with him tonight. He looks like he can do whatever he wants out there on the ice. Face-off coming up in the tween zone. We got Higgs out here to take it.
Face-off back to the point to Deshane, who's going to chip it in deep. Getting in behind the net, chasing after it. Is Brown, Colin Brown going to get to it? A little bit of hit there, but now coming down the other end. In on to Gamet, who's going to play it. Chip it over to the corner. Brown will come down and get it. He's going to take a bump. As you can see, the hitting starting to increase here midway through this game.
Couple good slashes here in the last couple of sequence. So now Gann's on the refs here. I'm not sure if Gann's coaches tonight, but they're on the ref with that slash.
Tom Dixon and Kirk Ease over there both giving it to the official.
Both coaches have had their turn now. We got Dixon going out in the second. Johnny Desjardins going out in the first. Nothing like a game here at the Lou.
Higgs here on the faceoff, going up against Melikon. And in the feet, one back to the D for Gann, who chips it up to the blue line, gets it up and out. Now a foot race for it. As on the stick, Colin Brown coming in, has Wayman with him. Shotgun save made by Webster with the glove.
Big save by Webby there. Tweed's getting aggressive in the offensive zone. McCann pinched, got burned there. They have to be aggressive down three here halfway through the game. So that's going to happen. Webster's showing he's on his game tonight. He's going to keep in it. Tweed's defense is going to get aggressive, start pinching. And I'm looking forward to the latter half of the game here.
Higgs on the draw, scrambled, but one back by Melikon, back in behind his net and wrapped over to the side boards. They chip it up and out of the zone. That, I'm not sure that hit
player on the bench, Josh. Faceoff should come out. Gann's player's hanging. Yeah, it does come out. Coming up. And the big line for Gann and Aquay looks like we got Paulowski, Dominique, and Higgs here. That's been the big line doing most of the damage tonight.
Puck sent in, stopped up by Webster, left for the D. As they're going to try to get that one out, send it up to neutral zone. That chip stopped up by Gann. Tweed had to keep that puck from going outside. Gann does a good move there to keep that one moving forward. Rubbed out. Oh, that was a big hit. That might stir something up as he's, it looks to be staggered a bit still. Just coming back into the play.
Zach,
I think that might have been Deshane.
And Rhino chasing the puck out. We got, we're talking. Ellison and Deshane, they're talking to the center. Nothing's happening. Meanwhile, Melisson down there all alone almost. Nice little hit by Rhino. And Higgs on the forecheck. Higgs and Jones going at it. Good play by Will Jones. Regroup. Take it along down to Ellison, who just threw the big hit on Deshane there. Ellison coming down, stops up to the net. Save there by Komet. 8:05 left to go in the second period, 7-4 Gannon Ockway.
And I would expect we'll see 44 probably stepping on the ice next time Nelson is out to see if he's gonna have to answer for that little bit of a play.
Yeah, Ellison didn't seem too interested in Shane, and we got the coach talking to the ref again on the side there, Josh, when he picked that up. I wonder what they're saying. They're talking about that hit from Ellison. Look clean from this angle.
I'm sure Gann's more angry about the fact that he was hit into the stanchion
more than
the actual hit itself. Battle won by Wiley and then sent out to the far side. Chipped up to the blue line, gets out. As Tweed intercepts in the neutral zone, spinning it back, trying to get in. A little bit of stop and shoved off the puck there with a little bit of a light push. And then a stick hacked out of the hands. As you can see, it's starting to fire up here.
Tweed bench getting a little angry again. Just a little slash of the stick. The boys just being boys here. I don't think there's anything about that. Looks like Tweed is a little frustrated over on the bench again because of that slash, but we've got 7:30 left. We'll see what happens. We got some words going on between Brown and BMO.
BMO's like a big lad. Coda gonna get 2 minutes for slashing.
Well, there was a penalty there.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Sending Gannock right to the penalty kill here. Tweed looking to get this 3 goals down to 2.
I did not see the ref's arm go up, but that's a big break for Tweed there. 7-4. Looking to get 7-5 in the power play. BMO wound up. BMO down to Purdy. Purdy in front. Ingram in front. We got Ingram, Purdy, and Doherty. Looks like BMO and then Murdoch here as well. Tweed regroups here, a minute 40 left in the power play. And Murdoch coming up over to Brody Morris. Brody coming in, nice pass across here to Purdy. Purdy to Doherty, the big sniper shot saved by Komet. And we got a scrum here. Doherty and Stellick.
Starting up here.
BMO's in there.
As the ref doesn't know what he's doing. He's pulled in there. He's just trying to get a hold of Stellick. As he knows, he's the big one in the group. I don't think you're going to get a fight out of this, but it looks like it's starting to fire up here at the loop.
We got some action here. Both teams a little unhappy. The defenseman come in. The faceoff might come out. But Stellick's showing he's trying to assert his dominance over the Oil King. Saying nothing's going to happen here. Doherty with his helmet off, skating away. All things considered, that's a pretty cool. Got more words here, Brown and Morris, so we'll see what happens.
I know Morris had a couple hits in the previous games, which seemed to maybe spark some of this as some retribution, but it looks like they're both going to the box.
4 and 44 to the box, two of the bigger guys in the team. We got Stellick, the former NHLer, and the former Belleville Bull, Brody Morris, going to the box. Who was a celeb in the Pay It Forward Sports Celebrity Golf Classic with Ronald Clark and Doug Gilmore. We'll see what BMO can do here.
Like I said, I can't see this game going without having a scrap, at least this series. And they're coming down to the wire. Tweed is looking like they got the bite now in this game.
They got the fight. They're going after the big guy, Stellick, which is what they need to do, get him off his game. That's his second or third trip to the box. So if they can get Stellick off their game, get some more power plays, that's what Tweed's going to look to do. A big discussion here. The refs need to clean this up. Look at how many guys are over the corner there. Why don't they just get one and one, get the captains over there. I mean, 7 guys over there. Refs need to get a hold of this game here.
That is something you'll find here in the USHL. The refs do lose control from time to time. It looks like an extra player going in the box for Tweed.
Did they give Tweed 2 here? That's the question.
We're waiting for them to get this all up on the score sheet, and then we'll let you know.
Looks like they gave Ingram, number 7, a penalty as well, so this could even up, but there's a couple.
It looks like Cam got an extra one as well.
Yeah, well, we got 2 each going, yeah. Doherty, the big score for Tweed, somehow escapes any punishment there, so we could see him again on his power play. Tweed is sending out the big unit. We got Murray free.
Dixon giving it again to the officials, as he is not happy with the way this game is turning out for Dan.
I thought he was walking away. No, he's still there. So the refs are here from both sides. It's an intense game. Guys, gotta love it here. And we got some chirping in the penalty box here. We got Stellick and BMO still talking.
Face off won by Gannakwe, and then chipped out of the zone as he'll go all the way down into Tweed zone, stopped up by Webster, played over to Will Jones, who's gonna try to get up and out of the zone. As a good play there by Brock Higgs, breaks that up and sends it down.
We still have a power play for Tweed here. And a face off here coming in Tweed zone. Webster has to force a cover here.
2 minutes for Welcome Tweed. Under penalty, number 44, Eric Sellick, and number 4, Chad Buchanan.
Still a lot of talking going on in the penalty box here.
Time of penalty, 12 minutes, 52 seconds.
Higgs tries to win that one, but one back to Jones by Tweed. Tweed does a little DAD, and now they're going to break out of their zone. 6:42 remaining here in this second period, and this game getting exciting as in comes Melikon trying to get in, but pinched off along the boards in the corner. Gannakwe trying to get out, goes in behind their net, chased down, a little hogtie there by Brown. Goes, looks
hand
like.
Pass.
I'm not sure if there's a penalty call coming.
No, it's a hand pass. Face-off's coming out. Hand pass on Tweed. Dominique coming out to kill the penalty here. You got to look out for him. He's been a dangerous threat all night. Tweed could not lose sight of him, even on the power play.
Back to Jones over to the far side, looking to get forward. As the time ticking down on the remaining time on Tweed's power play, unrelated to all the shenanigans that just took place. Play there, scramble in front of the slot. Shot, big save made by Command.
Tricoli's having an amazing game down there. This is his first chance on the power play tonight. He's maybe a guy that's been moved up the lineup here. He's had a difference tonight for Tweed. And Jones shot down, intercepted in front. Doherty down the side of the net. Circles back. Oh, bad pass there. Purdy needs to keep a head up as the penalty expires. We're back to 5-on-5 here.
Battle in deep with Brown and Purdy, but comes out on Gann's stick, up to center. Now comes in Brock Higgs, not alone as Palkowski centers it. Palkowski swoops it across. Can't connect with anybody. It's grabbed up by Tweed.
And Tricoli with a sloppy pass up through the middle zone here. Tweed needs to look for a change as we get Dominique and Higgs coming back. Palkowski drives the net. He's got a back door. Oh, nice look there by Brock Higgs. And Dixon throws it down low. Tweed's going to let the break out here. Got the fourth line here. Looks like Crothers coming in. Crothers shot. Oh, blocked by 61 Verbeek. Crothers still digging. Shot tipped. And we got Mainzy in front of the net. Going down low. Tricoli on an extended shift here.
In the feet, but bounces off to the sideboard. Turn quick, fired. And a shot by Reese takes the Tweed player off his feet. As Reese, very strong hitter for Gananoque.
Gananoque breaking out here. We got Verbeek and Kowalski here. And we got to feed Murray free. Here he comes, Murray. Goes 5-0
big save
by Kowalski. Murray falls to the 5-hole trap there. Mainzy in front.
Raymond dropped to Brown. Brown dodges that play. Comes in with speed. Looking into the corner. Looking, centering. Can't get that to settle down as he's going to come to the blue line and get knocked out to the neutral zone. Quick pass, though, by the D. Gets it right back for Gann. Wayman ticks it in behind the net. Stevens chasing it down. Throws a body. Can't get it as it comes over this far side here. Where Gann gets an intercept by Harris. Keeps it in. Down below the net. Turns and fire as he's coming out from behind the net. Save made by Webster.
And we got some pushing each other in front here, Josh. Nothing going to come this one, but it looks like penalties are over. We'll see you again after Tweed sent out here. We've got 3:31 left.
So we have a score sheet here with the roughing calls from all the players involved.
Yeah, we got Duchesne, Stelic, along with Ingram and Morris for Tweed here on that when two guys are in the box for both teams. Roughing's all around. They feel spend 2 minutes, feel some shame, now they're back.
Gann holding it in their zone now, turns up to a neutral zone, but it's intercepted by Tweed as they come in over the blue line, but offside, called by the officials, stopping the play at 3:10.
And Tricoli's back out, just like I was saying, maybe we should get Tricoli back out here. He's been a difference maker for Tweed. Moving up the lineup a little bit, gets back to ice time, needs some power play time. With Inger in the box here, serving that minor. Lions are going to redo that face off there, kick the Tweed guy out. Funk, Matt Funk coming to take the drop. For the oil kick.
Lots of confusion here with the officials. Puck out of play though. As this is starting to become a little bit out of control, the officials look like they're having a hard time controlling simple face-offs.
Tweed wants that in. Not gonna happen.
Selleck pulled off the ice for, well, there's a Cody Smith here.
Smith and Tricoli going out on the faceoff.
This jousting is getting a little bit out of control by these two.
And the ref's sending them.
Tweed's going to the box, is it?
No, I think he's sending both.
Both, okay. So Smith. And try Oakley Roots are going away. And it looks like we're gonna have some 5-on-5 action though.
Well, Smith had to be sent out for a reason there, Josh. He came out, started jealous with Tricoli right off the faceoff, didn't even get a puck drop, into the box.
I think they're looking to save Selleck so he can drop the mitts and do something serious.
And we got an icing call here with 2:50 left in the second period.
Holy shit. 2:50 remaining here in the second period. What a game has been, eh, Brendan?
It's been a great game so far. Lots of scoring, 11 goals. Both teams have put some pressure at different times. Tweed's kind of took over early in this second period here. We got a big run here by 16. Colin Brown took a run at Elson, who had the big hit along with Stanchion earlier. Maybe a little retribution for that.
You can tell Nelson is definitely a target out there right now.
For sure, yeah. They're not out, but I think it was Duchesne going to Stanchion. They may be target number 21 for Tweed, Zach Elson.
Face off one back to the point. Gann has it looking shot just wide the net. As they'll come over to the side boards, Duchesne will pinch in, uses by to block it, sends it right back around to the corner, but grabbed up by Jones as he'll send it across ice and wait for them to get a little bit of time, sending it out, trying to stretch, but couldn't get it as Kmet came out to play that puck. Tweed still on it, looking, sending it back to the point. Jones has that puck bounce on him as he had Palakowski bowing in on him. Duchesne pinches the forward off is out. Here comes Gianacque out the other way. Here comes Domingo over center or over the ice. Blue line offside the call.
Lucky break for Tweed there offside. We have Dominique and Hanks coming in. Two of the most dangerous players for Gianacque. But it looks like we got an offside here. Tweed's coming back here. Whoever looks like Darren Doherty's line. So it's first or second line against Herbie. And Stellick over on the wing.
Boy, he's going to stop that one up in behind the net before it come around. They get it at the blue and shot in. Puck was high, bouncing, and still staying in the slot. But Tweed's able to get out. One Tweed player went sprawling. Didn't see exactly what happened there, though. As Gann gets it in their zone, now trying to work it out. But Tweed keeping it in. Into the slot, couldn't get it. Back out to the point, and Tweed will have to retreat and tag back up.
Tweed's still going back here, 7-4. Looking, trying to put one in home here in the last minute and a half of the second period to make it a two-goal game. And here we go, Ingram coming in, over to Doherty. Doherty skate the stick, shot up high wide. And he got clipped there, coming through. Tweed, Granadello, we got Purdy. Purdy and Ingram on the cycle. Doherty up high, Gianacque takes over.
Latimer.
Big break pass, picked off by Allure. Tweed coming in, throwing in the corner.
Selleck with a drive.
Stellick cuts in. Goes wide on Murdoch. Murdoch with a turnover coming up. This was a deceptive speed here from Murdoch on that little end-end rush there. And Duchesne, he's been all over the ice tonight, Duchesne. One of the best, or sorry, that's Brown. One of the best players here, one of the best defensemen for Gannon-Ockwe. Over, we got Millington.
Good breakup play there. Again, working hard here to try to keep the Elastis where the score is at.
This is the second or third time BMO's been up leading the rush from the defensive defenseman for Tweed here. He's doing everything he can to tie it up and extend the series. and get it back to game four in Tweed. So after two, ladies and gentlemen, 7-4 for the Gananoque Islanders. Tweed goes 2-1 that period. They're going to love to come out and fight for their lives coming in third period.
Well, what a second period of play that was, getting much more physical. We almost had a scrap come out, but the refs got into it pretty quick. Lots of bodies in there, so only some roughing that came out of that. Score continuing to go up. They don't mind getting the score up here, keeping the goals going. What's your take so far on this second period of play and, you know, continuation from the first?
Yeah, I think Tweed came out really hard in the start of the second. Obviously, Coach John had some message for them. He's still talking to the ref right now as the Amoni comes out. But Tweed came out hard in the second. They got two quick ones. Webster's probably the story of the period for them. He's keeping in the game. He's made 5 or 6 huge saves in the second. And Tweed's going to have to look what they did. They had a great second period. They're going to have to continue with it in the second into the third.
So for the goals, big notable right now,
I'm joined by Super here back.
Oh, look who's back, Super.
Super, we were just talking about how great of a second period Tweed had. They came out hot early.
Yeah,
two
much big
goals.
Better.
And Webby might be the difference here.
Yeah. Webby stood on his head. I talked to Webby in between the first and second period. I said, Webby, all you got to do is shut the door, kid. Give us a chance to claw our way back into this hockey game. And we did. And we gave up that one goal, but I think it was all walking to that second period. And let me tell you one thing, Gananoque. The fans are getting their money's worth tonight because it's a great hockey game.
That's what I was saying earlier. They got their admission price. But now, that altercation that happened down in the corner there,
yeah.
There was bodies flying in. Everyone was donating into that one. It looks like they're not afraid to get onto this right now.
No. And what happens there is, Sellis is a big, strong boy. There's no doubt about that. Great hockey player. Good, played some time in the NHL, man. The guy, he's not had a cup of tea up there. So down there with Dole, you don't touch Father Time. You don't touch Dole. Dole's our guy. He's the number one centerman in the league, in my opinion. And he is an awesome hockey player, but you can't put your hands on him because that's what happens. Guys come in to defend their teammates, and that's what you want to see in hockey.
And big number four, Brody Morris, comes there. He was giving it to Sellis a little bit. And they were talking, I love Bemo. Bemo's the man. He came in. He won't take anything from anybody. And even an ex-NHLer. So I think Tweed has a little momentum here coming to this third, Super.
Yeah.
They had a hot start, kind of fizzled off a little bit, but hey, what's Coach John, what's the message Coach John's going to give here to the players coming to the third?
Just see the course. Keep doing what we're doing. We're doing good things. We're moving the puck well. We're getting lots of shots. We've got to get more traffic in front of Komet. That's a good goaltender right there. And if you can see the shot, he's going to make the save. So we got to get a lot more traffic in there and just keep staying the way we can play. That's the key. Play the way we can play. Stay out of that box over there and just play hockey and keep pushing. We'll claw our way back in this and we'll see you, everybody, back in Tweed on Sunday at 2:30. That's what's going to happen.
So you have the prediction right there from Super Dave. They're coming back. He's going to get out. He's going to enjoy the rest of his intermission. And that's, I think, a pretty good take so far on this second period. And right now, this series has been a great series. So before we finish off here in the intermission, what is coming up for Pay It Forward Sports here for other events other than the hockey tournament?
Yeah, so we have a big summer plan. So like everyone knows, we have our Celebrity Golf Classic every year. That's July 8th this year at Trillingwood Golf Course. We're going to have headliners out there like Wendell Clark, Doug Gilmore. And what it is you get to come out and you get to golf with one of these former NHLers on your team for the whole day. It's a great day. So last year, I think it was Josh Dockstader got the honor. He played 18 holes with Doug Gilmore. We had some other guys play 18 holes with Wendell, Brad May, some other huge names from around the Leafs, the Habs. We got some big Habs coming this year. Stefan Richey is going to be attendance. But a recent event we got coming up, May 11th, Trillium Woods. We have a golf tournament coming up, and it is for the TPC Sawgrass Invitational. So how it works, teams of four are going to come out to this tournament, and the winning team of the golf tournament gets a trip for four, 3 nights at a hotel, and they are going to golf the amazing TPC Sawgrass, which is one of the most prestigious public courses in the world, and where the PGA Tour goes. So a once-in-a-lifetime prize for sure.
Well, it's great to hear again. You can check out the website for you guys is
www.payforwardsports.ca.
Perfect. Check them out if you want to look at getting into any of the events. We're going to take a minute, get our voices a little break here, and we're coming back for this exciting third period. Tweed only down by 3. They can bring it back. They have the firepower, but Jake Komet right now is also standing on his head, doing a great job. He has 4 goals against on 31 shots, but they have been great shots.
Absolutely. So Komet's going to come out here in this third period and look to show Gananoque why the investment in him got the trade deadline. They picked him up, and he's going to come out here and try to seal the game for them.
Right. Webster going to do what he can to keep that net shut down back there to give the forwards all the chance they can to bring it back. Will there be some fisticuffs? We don't know. It's been pretty energetic. It could be coming, but at the same time, too, in these playoff games, you don't want to be the one to cause an issue. So.
No, I think it could be a pretty calm period just because you don't tweet not looking for the box. But with a couple goals for Gananoque, who knows, Josh, we might have some fireworks. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen.
We'll be back after this intermission. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. We got a minute up on the clock. I'm getting the camera set up here for the second intermission. It's going to be a good one. So, really, at this point, like you said, it could be a relaxed game. Might not have too much rest stuff going on, unless the score gets out of hand. Tweed definitely can't be spending time in the box, but they do have to do something here to get in and more control in the zone, as a lot of the chances have been coming off the rush.
Yeah, for sure. No, a lot of the few chances haven't come off the rush, and some setup shots from the point. But Tweed's going to throw the kitchen sink at Gannon Aqua here starting the third period. They have no choice. Their season's on the line. They're a proud team, and you never know what happens back in Tweed. They have the best fans in the league. The bar is going to be packed for game four, so they're looking for anything to get it back there.
Exactly, and it's going to all come down to this now. We have a final 20 minutes, unless Tweed can tie it and send overtime. This is where it's going to end for them this season. So, 3 goals down and 20 minutes to go. Tweed's got to make a big difference here.
I'll give you a prediction here, Josh. 9-8 Tweed in overtime. The Oil King are coming back.
9-8 Tweed. I said in the first intermission to some fans, I didn't think Tweed was getting over 5 on Komet. So, we'll see what happens if it goes overtime or if Komet can hold them down to 5. And those fans have some feelings. We'll see what happens here, but here comes the Gananoque Islanders. With that, they'll come in to set up for the face-off here, the third, and Gananoque gonna win it back to Domingo, sends it back to the D, as they're gonna move it, cycle it back. Gananoque in control right now with the 3-goal lead. We'll see what happens here as that puck gets down, no icing, as it's chipped by Webster to the sideboards, as it'll be chipped out by Ingram. It let that puck bouncing through Palakowski, got it, caught in his body, but then scooped up in the neutral zone, or in the slot, by the Oil Kings. Gan turns it back quickly. Gananoque gonna get out of the zone. Chipped in over at the bench. The rest will grab the puck, bring it just outside the blue line by the Gananoque bench.
Good read there by number 8, Graham Brown coming in, playing Doherty, tight gap. Gan's gonna come out and play it safe this period, it looks like. Maybe play a little bit of trap and try to slow Tweed down through the neutral zone. Big 3-goal lead, they have a huge advantage coming to this third. And they're looking to clog up the neutral zone here. You can see not much of a forecheck by Gan to start this period here. And here comes Bimo coming down the wing. Left shot, fired, blocked by Duchesne. And coming back, looks like we have Higgs. Higgs to the meet. Higgs cuts in. Shot saved. Good save by Webster. Squeak through him on the 5-hole back door. Tweed looking to box him out here. Back to Duchesne. Shot saved by Webby again. And we got a break. Murray free, launches up, we got Rhino. Rhino come down the breakaway, shot saved by Komet. What a glove stop. That's 2 breakaway saves in the last 5 minutes for Komet to keep the game close. And oh, Dominique comes in and rings it up high at Webby, who looks to be okay here.
Webster right now with an injury to him, having to put back in Morrison, would definitely cause some issues here for Tweed trying to bring this game back, as Webster has just been lights out since he's come in.
He's been a difference maker for sure. He's only allowed 2 goals here in the last 2 periods. He's faced tons of shots. Looks like the trainer's coming to see him. But speaking of goalies here, Josh, a huge save by Komet. That's a save on Murray Free and Rhino, 2 of the top players here.
That's why I put my 5 goals there with Stockwood Komet. He seems to be able to play pretty big in the big games. And this is why, as you're seeing here earlier, showing it in this third period.
Yeah, absolutely, Josh.
Draw one by Tweed as they're going to try to clear it out here to the neutral zone. Bouncing puck, causing some issues as Salek grabs that up, sends over to Versteeg, who's going to chip it in. He'll go in and be grabbed up quickly by Murda behind his net as he's trying to avoid Verbeek. It gets sent to the sideboards now, chipped all the way down past everybody. He's going to go for icing as it goes in beside the net of Komet and will come all the way back down the ice into Tweed. So
Gannon Aquay, it looks like both teams lead him out here. We got Verbeek, Stalik, and Stevens staying out against the Tricoli line here for Tweed. Oh, Verbeek goes forward off the faceoff. Good play. And we got Allure dumping it up. I'm sorry, check that. No, that was Allure. Coming down, we got 84. We got Matthew Wilby coming down low.
Salik made a good move there to avoid a hit by stopping up with that puck. And now battling with it down the corner as he's trying to get that puck, but they can't get control of it. As it's in the feet, now on the solid stick, off the boards, and it goes up and hits the netting, causing a whistle. And I think that one's gonna come back into the Gannon Aquay zone.
Yeah, absolutely. Gannon Aquay leaving the line out again. That's a long shift here. Oh, here comes the change. Maybe a little line matching from Coach Dixon. He sees the fourth line for Tweed come out, and he sends out the third or fourth line for himself. So a little line matching here from the Gannon Aquay coach.
The early draw, the drop there is going to get a whistle. One back to the point. Nelson shot. He's going to get tipped there by Mainz, but couldn't dial in on the net as it goes just beside. Now looking to clear it out up to Smith, who gets it out over the blue line. Chips in the neutral zone, sticking with it as he's going to send it in the zone, but it gets caught up by Tweed as they're going to stop it and now drive up this close side here, trying to bring it in, getting some speed. Main sends it over to the far side as there'll be a chase for it as Dixon gets there first, sends it behind his net, and then they're going to clear it up and out of the zone, trying to spring a little bit of a breakaway, but couldn't get that one as that puck is going to stay down low as they battle. Bodies bouncing, is going to go in behind the net for Gannon Aquay. Pull, move made right in front of the crease. Luckily, that didn't cost Gannon Aquay.
Coming down here, Gannon Aquay. Nice hit by Morris. Long shift here for Tweed. Gannon Aquay's got them caught here, it looks like. Tweed's able to get out, get a change here. And Purdy chasing back, going after Reese. And Jared McCann. McCann flips it up, knocked down by Higgs. Higgs and McCann battle for it along the wall here. Doherty in support. Along with it, looks like Smith for Gannon Aquay. Turnover! Doherty's off to the races. Doherty cutting it on Komet. Doherty's up front hand. Save by Komet! What a save. That's three breakaway saves in the last 7 minutes of this game from Jake Komet.
I'm holding my prediction right now.
And that's going to be a highlight for sure on Ballers and Hockey Nation later tonight.
Good call, Brendan. Good call.
I'm always here for a plug, Josh. Always for a plug.
They're going to get that net set back in. I don't know if you know, but Jake Komet's nickname is Cement, and I think he's got cement feet because he has no problem knocking that net off.
He stole that. He held the post strong there for sure. Absolutely. And out, BMO shot, up and out. And we got the two top lines over both teams here. We've got Doherty, Purdy, and Ingram going up against the Bolovsky line, and we got Duchesne and Brown on defense.
Hook shot. Oh, that was up high in Brock Higgs' chest. He was able to still hold it and get over to the far side.
And Tweed resets here. McCann off to Mallinson. Over to Brody Morris. Brody cutting in. And Dominique gets hit down low. Found eight. Oh, and Graham goes over to Morris. Morris looking his own offense here. We got a battle in the corner. Ingram, Purdy. And we got a turnover. Nice play there by big number 22, Brain Allure, to stop that rush from happening. Dumped in from Gannon Aquay. Murray freeze down there. Looking reset, gonna bump it back. Bumps it over to Allure. Allure's going for a little skate. Big guy cuts through. Feeds it wide. Looks like Rhino coming in. Rhino blocked by number 3, Sean Dixon. Mallinson Going down low, Bundy Murray. Batted out of the corner. Number 13, Justin Steven takes for Gannon. He's one for the skate. Murray free going over, lays the body. That's what Murray does. He's a hitter, folks. Haven't seen much from him tonight in terms of the body, but that's one of those games for you.
With that icing, they did stay just while that play was going on. 413 in attendance, so just shy of what would probably be a sellout here for Gannockway.
Yeah, wherever the Tweed Oil King goes, fans show up. They are one of the best attended teams in the league. So shout out to the Tweed Oil Kings fans for packing this party. And tons of Gannockway fans here. That corner by their rinks packed, or by their bench.
Puck in the zone. Quick under as Verbeek trying to get it. Takes a little bit of a bump. That puck's going to get sent out to center ice, bouncing on Chris Latimer as he fires it in deep. And we'll let Tweed chase it down. Verbeek giving pressure, trying to get the puck turned over, gets it, bouncing into the slot as that one saved up by Webster. Oh,
there's
no, out of play.
Selleck balancing.
And again, Selleck not being afraid to get in there and start to ask some people if they'd like to have a little bit of a fisticuffs.
I don't think he's going to find any takers tonight unless the game gets a little more out of hand. Tweed obviously needs to stay calm here, stay out of the box, and maybe draw a penalty if they can.
Looks like they're going to get some different
Dixon's
players
going
on
at
the
him
ice.
Again. Dixon's going at him again. It's about time they look at center of the coach here. He can't be coming down this many times.
I'm sure if he's going to find himself, I might be. He's still there. I'm not sure. Don't think he's been ejected yet. Still on the bench.
And the fourth line for Tweed, we got Mainsey, Millington, and Crothers back out. Big hit by Jones. Number 77, Dwayne Wayman.
Connection with out. Webster by Coda. Looks like nobody's going to go after Coda for that.
Good play there by Crothers, get it over to Millington. Millington on the forecheck. And sends it down on Webby. Webby's gonna regroup in Elson, who we've seen in quite a bit of pain here in the first and second intermission, doing some stretches. He's battling through something here for the Oil Kings for sure. And that puck's out of play. That's gonna be a face off in Gannockway zone with 13:49 left to go in the third period.
So 6 minutes, 11 seconds down, Tweed. Not able to get this three-goal deficit cut into here. Time starting to become a factor for the Oil Kings.
Absolutely, Gannockway just playing it safe, not letting them get much speed through the neutral zone. And they're playing a smart game here, looking to win, go to the finals for the third year in a row.
We'll have to make it through the semis first, but definitely trying to make it there.
We got a call coming on Gannockway. Number four, Chad Duchesne's going to the box for holding. And Tweed's going to get a power play here with 13:33 left to go in the third period. And this is a chance. They need one here, Josh. It's do or die time for Tweed. They're sending the first unit out. Looks like we got Doherty with Purdy and Ingram. And we got Brody Morris on the point.
This is where Jake Komet is going to show his worth if he can shut down these Oil Kings here on this prime opportunity with only 13:33 left.
The Oil Kings have a set play here. They need to make it happen. They need to go to something that works right off the draw. One back by Verbeek, who's been a great on the faceoffs today.
I got left in behind the Tweed net. Tweed needs to figure out what they're going to do here as Gannockway keeping that puck away from their net. Good save made by Komet. Now that puck over into the corner. That's a good battle. No call coming, but fans want something as they saw the little bit of the cross-check and shoving there from the Tweed players. Picked up by Brody Morrison, cutting through. Has to dodge a check. Shot coming. And he scores!
Number four, Brody Morris puts it home. And BMO makes it 7-5. What a goal by number four. And he even has some words for Selleck as he skates by, saying Tweed's still in it. We're still here, 7-5 here, with 12:59 left the third period. What a goal by former Battle of Old Brody Morris.
And we'll see if Selleck tries to throw Tweed off here on this shift.
Absolutely, he's been matched up against Mellison on the top line a few times here in this period, so that looks to be the matchup Higgins or that Dixon's chasing the Gantt coach. And Tyler Mellison, he's a very dynamic player, an offensive wizard. Haven't seen him do much here tonight. He's going to look to do something for Tweed. He gets the puck through the neutral zone, and Stelic's on him on the back check. They do not want to let him go. Shot, Murray got it! Big rebound. A little shaky there by Komet. And dumped in by Lair. Sorry, that's Ellison. And Jones coming up on Stelic. A little bump. And Gannon Ockways going to regroup here with 12 minutes to go in the third period. Skating it out. Dish over to Stelic. Stelic looks to the middle to Stevens. Murray free takes it on at Stelic. Who says something to him? Play continues. Murray free here and Rhino. Here comes Rhino looking to wind it up. No icing by the linesman. And looks like the Crowley line's coming out through the Tweed against the Verbeek line for Gannon Ockway. We got a battle in the corner here.
Good opportunity. Swooped away by Gann. Right in
Murdoch
front.
Needs
up
to be on his horse here. Good cover there by Allaire, number 22. Deflecting the corner, Allaire. Back to Murdoch coming up. Number 90, dishes off the boards on the long pass. Good pass up to Tricoli. Tricoli at short side. Oh, good save by Komet. Komet is on. Tricoli and Komet have been two of the best players for both sides tonight. Going one-on-one there. And in front of the net here, Gannon Ockway on the forecheck, making a line change. Out comes Pulzowski coming up high. We got the puck frozen down there in the corner. The ref's letting him play. They're digging finally. We got a stop and play with 10:48 left in the third period. Looks like Duchesne was down there battling with number 22, Brayden Allaire.
Time ticking down, 10:48 remaining, but Tweed has been able to cut into the three-goal deficit, now only seeing two. And if they can get one more here in the next couple minutes, they're going to be sitting with an opportunity to bring this back.
Just chip away, be patient. That's the name of the game for Tweed. Don't let anything happen. Defensively, you gotta keep it within two here. Bad bounce off the stanchion. Cut in front, scores! What horrible luck for Tweed. The puck goes up, hits the stanchion, kicks back down, and Higgs makes them pay. That's two very unlucky goals for against Tweed tonight, and that could be the nail in the coffin of the Oil King.
Gann Ockway getting that three-goal lead back. Where do they like to sit?
Yeah, weird play there. It looks like the defenseman just threw it up. Looks like it hit the blue stanchion over there. Kick back in. Tweed was fleeing the zone. And just a bad case of bad luck there for the Oil King.
Bad luck
for
Tweed.
They won't give up. They're coming back. Brody Morris looking to do it again. Chip a 2-0 lead. Morris in on the forecheck. He's an animal down there. Turnover. Purdy going to look in front to Ingram. Ingram down low. Ingram. Tweed is getting their chances here, folks. This is their best game of the series, hands down. But Gannon Ockway, again, just too much offensive firepower. And they get their chances. They are not missing. And Polanowski looking up to Dominguez. Chipped away by Ellison. Tweed desperately trying to get something going. Purdy chips it down low. Purdy and Doherty. And we got a whistle here, not sure why.
Not sure if it was icing or if they were calling it offside. Oh no, the net came off behind Komet.
We got cement skates here. Komet kicking the net off again, looking for a little break.
He needs to look at himself, getting some new true skates, light as can be.
And Mellison, gonna take the draw against Verbeek. Two good face-off men here, big draw. Coming up in the Anakwe zone. Verbeek, clean back, Murray free on the forecheck. Skating around, being broken by Latimer. Latimer rushing it up, down Verbeek shot. Saved by Revy again. Stevens has the puck down low.
Celek's on the forecheck against Jones, bumps him off the puck.
We see Free giving Celek a little shove there, Celek giving one back, but the question is, will the miss come off? Because shoving doesn't mean anything.
Celek looks at Marie Free and says, what are you going to do about it? Marie, not much there.
We'll see.
Looking to come back.
At this point, if you're going to start shoving, you might be ready to drop the mitts.
Good play by Ellison there. He's going to come up. And then Rhino. Big hit.
On Rhino.
What a good hit. And Rhino didn't want another part of him there. So, gets in deep. Stelic and Murray here. Can on this, Josh. Here we go. Oh. Stelic's right on him still.
And Stelic's going to make his way to the bar bench. So.
Timeout coming from Gannon Aqua here. Off the icing call. They do not want to let us get a 2-goal lead.
No, I don't think he hasn't indicated it yet.
He did indicate timeout.
To the referee?
Yes, he's saying he can't do it. The ref's saying no. Maybe no timeout's off icing in the OHL.
Potentially. Behind the net. Latimer chips it up to the sideboards. They're going to send it out. Grabbed up. Oh, and a chance here. And that just gets chipped off the stick. And a play by Webster. Is that going to be touched or is it going to be a call?
Tipped.
The linesman saying it touched. It touched. So I don't think we're going to have a call. But as you can see right now, getting an earful from Stevens is the official. But there'll be no call as the linesman says it got touched.
And the Tricoli line back out here. Big move there by Wilby. This defensive pairing for Gannon Aqua is rock solid here, Josh, between we got Duchesne and Brown. Nothing's getting by them right now.
No, definitely big. Getting very physical out there with those two.
Well, they play every other shift. It seems like those guys are there 30 minutes a night, it looks like. In front here. Turned over, turned and fired. Saved by Webby. Shot by Coda. We got Coda, Smith, and Aiden Harris out on the ice for Gannon Aqua. Shot fired in by Duchesne. A little wide.
Puck bouncing in the feet right there in the corner. As three Tweed players were able to grab that off the Gannon Aqua player. They're going to send it in. Not too much behind it, allowing Gannon Aqua to get to it first. Duchesne going to walk, cut across the line, has some time, going to bounce it off the boards. And is going to get chipped in deep as Gann will chase it down. Holding this 3-goal lead strong here with 7:30 remaining. Tweed needs to figure something out. They're running out of time.
Dominique wide over. I think that's Higgs. Nope, not Higgs. Paul Wierski. Y'all remember that line. And here comes Brothers. Brothers takes it down the wall. Looking for Mangy in front.
Good opportunity. Just couldn't connect with that one. As Gann had the player tied up.
And covered up there. Higgs makes sure that the puck can play faceoff. In Tweed zone with 7:06 left in the third period.
Not the guy you would want to have a breakaway, so that worked out in Webster's favor. Because Higgs.
I want to see Higgs coming down on the alone. Or Dominique for that matter.
They've been very dominating today. Repeat coming into the faceoff. It's in the feet. Tweed's defense pulls it out. Sends it to the far side. They're going to try to get down. But a good breakup play made there by the D for Gann. Gets that one broken up in the neutral zone. Tweed has to recollect themselves back deep in their zone.
Good look there by Ellison. Down in and down. Gordy gets it. Gordy comes in. Shot. Score! Number 23, Darren Gordy gets Tweed back with it too. He goes high cheddar there. And Tweed's back in the game, guys. 7 minutes left. Lots of time left for the Oil King to claw their way back. And Josh, my prediction of 9-8 still holds.
Yours holds, mine's out. But I can tell you there's enough time for Tweed to bring this back. It's a big hill to climb, but they can do it.
That's going to be a great replay on Abolish the Talky Nation there. Darren Doherty comes in. He goes high glove on command, and he puts it absolutely in the perfect spot. Nothing he can do there. And timeout, Gannon Ockway. They do not like how this is playing out.
Definitely. I got a perfect shot of it, and yes, right over top of the glove of Komet. Now, a lot of times, Tweed has been trying to work Komet's blocker side. That's the time that they switched over to the glove side and just ripped it by.
This is Tweed's most offensive game of the series for sure so far. It's been a tight, checky game through two, or tight, checky series through two periods here, but we've got the overtime clock running here. We have 80 shots so far between these two teams. What a great game. Game three of the first round of the NOSHL. Gannon Ockway's looking to move on to play the winner of Smith Falls Deserado, and Tweed's looking to bring back game four to the Tweed Nation tomorrow. Ingram coming in, same line for Tweed. Ingram shot up high, bounced up Purdy. Allaire down to Purdy. Purdy over to Darren Doherty. Purdy, Ingram, and Doherty all down low for Tweed. Back to the point to Will Jones. And it's out. And held again. Gann is just dumping it in here. They have taken their foot off the gas a little bit. Playing more defensive hockey. It's a couple of dumpings in a row.
That shot was right on and had to be glove saved by Webster. Gann is definitely, when they are throwing it down the zone, they are trying to keep it on net, though.
Oh, for sure, yeah. I think any face-off in the odd, it was always a good face-off for Gann. So they're looking to slow it down. Tweed's looking to play a high-paced game. We got the two captains lined up on the face-off again. Still talking.
Shot. Ray hard. Costello.
He might have some words for Grail on that, or Brown on that one. Rhino chips it in. We got Brown and Nelson going back. They play back in it. Kind of bump it up the boards there to Stellick. Stellick with a very good pass down to Shane. Shane is so smooth with the puck. You can just tell he was a good player. I'm not sure where he played, but I would guarantee it's some high level hockey for sure. Fly in the zone here, Tweed is. We got Rhino up three blue lines. Dixon looking for an icing call. Doesn't happen. As we approach 5 minutes to go in the third period here, Tweed down 8-6. Looking to make one last push. BMO over to McCann. McCann up to Funk. Funk coming down on the forecheck. We still have Duchesne and Brown on out here. Four game off. Return over. Brock Higgs coming back. Higgs and Paul Groski. Higgs cutting the middle. Shot saved by Webby. Webster's been unbelievable tonight.
Yeah, if he had come in from the beginning of the game, those, I believe, three goals scored on Morrison would have Tweed in the lead right now.
Yeah, he was pulled at 5-2, I believe. Oh, what's the rest of the game here?
And it being
for some reason, I'm not sure why.
The pull of Morrison earlier didn't seem like it was all on him either. He was trying to spark the team as they were getting manhandled at that moment by Gann.
Something's going on here. I'm not sure why. He gave Brody Morris a penalty for some reason. But luckily, he did. I'm not sure what happened there, John. But it looks like number four, Brody Morris, is going to the penalty box.
It's on the board, so Gann's going to get a power play. And Morris still giving it to the official.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he did. I didn't see anything yet, but he's still giving it to him. Beagle's no stranger letting the refs know. And he is certainly letting them know right now.
Based off one by Gann Ockway in the zone. Back to Duchesne. Duchesne over to Verbeek. Shot! And a good save made. A rebound shot! A big save!
What a save by Webster there. That was on Higgs. who has your goal on the night. Big glove save.
It might be battle of the saves on Ballers and Hockey Nation tonight.
It won't just be saved, Josh. He's got some good goals. But again, Duchesne's out there. It seems like for the
another big save by Webster.
Webster's down and out in front of Duchesne. Shot scores. Number four, Chad Duchesne puts it home, and I'm afraid that's going to end it. The ref is going to kick out Brody Morris right here. Four going out off the penalty, and he's going to let it go. Horrible officiating on the ref. I'm not sure what people did to deserve that. We got some time to fit in. Up comes Rutledge. Chris Rutledge got some words for him. An old rat coming out there to calm him down. That boy rat.
The fans definitely have passion on both these teams, and it's showing here.
Tripoli coming in. Tripoli sets up across the front. That's the third time. They got to take those posts in.
They need some piranha pegs.
Josh, can you pick up this fight in the stands here? This might be more action on the ice.
There might be more action happening in the fans than the stands.
Looks like UFC Noche here. I don't know if you saw that.
The team from Tweed Kick trying to get more into the dressing room as the fans are still giving it here too. The players.
Got super here in it with the fans too. It's a great atmosphere here.
If you got a chance to jump on to the Tweed Oil Kings, you're gonna get a first-hand view of that argument, as it's been just wild here in the Gananoque Arena. Face off, finally they're able to get back to gameplay after the kick out of the player and the fixing the net argument with the fans. And now Gann looking to finish off this game three and send Tweed home for the season to clear out their lockers. Oh, and a big, oh, big a save by Webster.
Here comes Cross Keister Brown. He's on with that glove tonight.
Webster's definitely not done tonight, as he's trying to do everything he can to keep his team the option to get a couple quick goals.
Yeah, he has a difference maker tonight, absolutely 100%. I'm going to play the fight here in the stands. We still got the trainer, Chris Rutledge, for the Tweed Oil Kings, going to ask the fans here. And Darren Doherty, back out to McCann. McCann bumps it back down to Doherty, over to Allaire. Allaire, no, Ellison, sorry. And we got a break here. Verbeek coming down to Stelic. Stelic on McCann. Good bump there by Purdy on Stelic up to Ingram. Ingram looking for Doherty. Doherty, patient. Ellison coming down too. And we got a penalty coming behind the play here. Number three, John Dixon's going to go to the box. And we got a power play for Tweed.
Dropping the call for Dixon. And Tweed has had a little bit of life in the third. They can make it a two-goal game if they can get one in here fast.
Well, I wonder what Coach John Desjardins is thinking here. Is he going to pull the goalie? I think the goalie's going to come right now. 3 minutes left. Tweed's going to throw everything they got at Gananoque right here, Josh.
They just called their timeout.
30-second timeout for the Oil Kings here as they drop their best plays as their season hangs in the balance here with 3 minutes left in the third period.
And right now, Jake Kmat could end Tweed's season by shutting the door for the final 3 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. Here it's going to come down to Bradley Kmat, Duchesne, and Brown. Graham Brown is going to be on the ice all the time together, so it's going to come down to that number one deep pair and Kmat. So we're going to close the door. Tweed's going all out here. We got Melanson, Tricoli, Murray Free, Rhino, and it looks like we got Will Jones and Ellis on the point. 6-on-4 here for the Oil King.
Based off one out of the zone as the Oil Kings got to chase that one back. As we cut down to the final 3 minutes here.
Here comes Jonesy, Will Jones cutting in. Good pass to Tricoli. Tricoli turned over. And that's out. That's everything Gann's looking for. That puck is curling over. I believe they call it icing when they're on the power play. That's going to come back to center ice here. A little brave part by the linesman. Maybe watching the fight in the stands a little too much.
Never a lack of entertainment.
Back in here with the face-off and center ice, Josh.
So this actually worked out negative for both teams.
Yeah, it did. Yeah, we want to keep the play going for sure.
Face-off won by Tweed as they're going to move it around again. Cutting down to the final 2.5 up here as they got to get a goal to start breaking in here to Gannock's lead.
Net is empty again, folks. We got Higgs going against Jones. Higgs turns it over. And we got 492. Brock Higgs, former Kings of Crockett. Great season by the Oil. Hard fought effort tonight, but they are going to come up short again to the Gananoque Islanders, who seem to have their number in the playoffs. We got some talk on the faceoff here. Looks like 72. And Purdy. No. Tweed's going to play it straight here. They're still going. Dowdy, Ingram, battling over here with Jack Wiley. Purdy looking, over to Allaire. Allaire's going to wind it up here for the shot. Nope, goes in front. And Gann goes solo. Nope, not empty net anymore. My mistake. We got a minute 46 to go in the third period and possibly the series here as Gann looks to make a clean sweep 3-0 over the Tweed Oil King. Tweed making one last push. We got Purdy. Purdy looking for the man out front. Wiley goes to clear. Stopped there by Allaire. Darren Dowdy down to Purdy, down to Ingram. And that's out again with a minute 20 left. And the chant started the na 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 from the Gananoque fans.
Didn't get a lot of traction though, unfortunately.
Like a wave in a Jays game, one person's enough.
107 remaining, and Tweed will be going home to clear out the lockers until next season. And Gann will be looking to move on to the next round to face off, as you said, Deserano or Smith Falls for the semifinals.
Tweed's still going all out here. Murray Free, he's the guy I never thought to give up. Still grinding, going at Whaley here with a few minutes left. And McCann. McCann up to Murray, turnover. Puck back down here, 41 seconds left in the game and the series. Jonesy coming in, dumps it in deep. Got a little hit there by Colin Brown, the 16 on Gananoque. Gann's looking to ice this here. The start of the bus chant has a little more traction here, John. Got a lot of small. get a little chirps. That's okay. It's hockey, folks. We get it. And 7 seconds left. Dumped in here by number 16, Colin Brown, and that's going to be it. The Gananoque Islanders are moving on to the second round. Great game by both these, 10-6 for Gananoque. Great job done by Jake Komet, Brock Higgs, Kevin Dominguez, and of course the coach here, Tom Dixon, who led his team to victory. And here's the handshake line, one of the most respected aspects of playoff hockey. That's why hockey's great. Guys battled for 3 games here on their days off from work. And they're gonna shake hands and congratulate each other and wish them good luck. Great season by the Kings. Okay. On to round two.
Second star. Number 17 from your Islanders, Kevin Dominguez. Your first time on the Islanders, number 92, Brock Hayes. Keep your eyes on the ground, ladies and gentlemen, to find out when our last game is. I'll be coming next week sometime. Should be here at Hog All Summer.
So with that, the handshake line, that will be the end of the series between these two teams. And it looked like cooler heads did prevail. There's only a couple scrums in that. No actual tilts in this, which is surprising between these two teams. But such a great series. You know nobody wanted to cause a fight that could be ended for the season. So another year where Gananoque is able to get by Tweed and move in. They've had a great rivalry between these two teams over their first 3 seasons in this league. But right now, Gananoque holds the record and the advancements. So moving on to the next series, we're going to see Gananoque move on to face off Deserano or Smith Falls. What do you expect here for the next round for Gananoque?
Yeah, well, I think it depends who Gananoque is going to play, right? Smith Falls is a very defensively responsible team. They're going to come out, they're going to play a hard game. On the other hand, Deserano, they're all offense all the time, so it's going to depend who they play here. Game 2 is going on tomorrow. Game 3 is going on tomorrow there. Hard to talk here with all the crowd interacting here.
We have a little commotion. It never ends here in Gananoque until the fans are all cleared out of the arena.
But anyway, Gananoque is going to be a favorite against anyone that comes out here round two. They show by they're a good team. They got tons of firepower with Higgs, Dominique, Kirby. They got Stevens, also that defensive crew, Abu Shane, and Brown. It's going to be a great series, and I think Gan will be the favorite going to round two in the East here.
For sure, and Jake Komet stood on his head, let in more than I thought he was going to, but still got himself the victory. So that he's 2-0 now in these playoffs. Lee Hertz has the other win for Gananoque. We'll see what happens coming into the second round. We do want to thank you for tuning in and following along. Again, please check out Pay It Forward Sports online. You want to give them that website one more time?
www.payitforwardsports.ca. We run the best tournaments and fundraisers for your charity not for profits. We're looking to make a little money this year for your charity. Contact Pay For Sports, payforsports.ca, and we will create a fundraising event that shows off your not-for-profit group and make you the money you need for your funds for the year.
Perfect. Thank you very much for tuning in, and I will see you guys at the next game.